Welcome to the famous Lakeside Country Club here in Frimley Green.
Often fondly called the home of darts, this history-making venue has been holding major tournaments since 1986.
Fast forward 36 years and the Lakeside will host the first Masters tournament on the new World Seniors Tour.
A total of 24 Masters titles are between the players, and for once, Phil the Power Taylor is not the most decorated in the event.
That honour sits with Trina Gulliver, who has 6 Masters titles to her name, but 3 times Masters champions Martin Adams, Lisa Rashton and Bob Anderson are also in the field.
It's going to be a great weekend of darts.
Welcome to the Jennings Bet World Seniors Darts Masters. Double play. The Dart Father is here, Bobby George, a leading light in darts. I tell you what, for approaching 50 years on the hockey or on a television screen, you're going well, mate. You are seriously going well.
You want to see me in the mornings.
Now, tell me, what contribution would you say the Lakeside, as a venue, has given to the sport of darts?
Well, the thing about Lakeside, the ceiling's low. It's not like a high church or something. Don't get no echoes with it. The crowd you get at these sort of tournaments in the Lakeside give you order. That's one thing. It's the atmosphere. It's the atmosphere. You walk in the venue and you can feel it as you walk in. I've got so many memories here.
Well, exactly. When I walked in this morning, the memories, they all come flooding back. Great champions, great players have all graced the stage and they've all won tournaments here, but many more just in qualifying in itself was a great honour. And I tell you what it said to me, the Seniors Tour gives them an opportunity to come back. You said on social media today, turn back the years. They ain't coming to mess about though, are they? They come to do as well as they can.
Oh yeah, because once you're a dart player and a champ, you think you're going to do the same all the time. But like my old saying goes, if you don't use it, you lose it. But I can't say, I think these boys have put more in it since the World Seniors.
Yes, we had the World Seniors Championship at the Circus Tavern in February, and what struck me was a lot of the players thought, I want to do this, but if it don't work, boy, you feel bad.
Oh, well, look at Phil Taylor, he must have felt that sick. Sick as a pig, he must have been, because I thought he'd come out flying and that, he practiced, but he didn't do enough. But I bet he don't come out like this now.
Look, I'll tell you what, the atmosphere is building, isn't it? There have been so many great nights and you can feel this building already, can't you?
I love it. It's a lovely feeling there. You can't buy it. You have to be here to know it.
A quick reminder that anyone that's hit bullseye in years can play on the Seniors Tour. Let's get going. So let's look at the draw. If Kevin Paynter can beat David Cameron, easier said than done, he will play Robert Thornton in the last 16. That would be a repeat of a Seniors World Championship semi-final. Robert went on to win the title, of course. Terry Jenkins will play Richie Howson, and the winner will play 6 times Masters champion Trina Gulliver in the last 16. The winner of the Roland Shelton-Wayne Jones match will play 3 times BDO World Champion, 3 times Masters champion Martin Adams. That's one of tomorrow's matches. But back to tonight. Paul Lim is about to play John Part, and the winner will return to the stage later tonight to play none other than Phil Taylor for a place in the quarterfinals. The Seniors Tour has tempted Phil out of retirement, and it gives him the chance to add to his grand total of 200-plus tournament wins. So, tonight's order of play. First up, any moment now, Paul Lim against John Part. Then it's Kevin Paynter against David Cameron, Roland Shelton against Wayne Jones, and Phil Taylor will play the winner of the Paul Lim-John Part match. Bob, I tell you what, the format in the opening rounds, well, it's the best of 7 sets, but it's the best of 3 legs to a set.
Yeah.
I tell you what, if you have a slow start, you have an early exit, you could be out.
Yeah, obviously, it's a lot of sets, best of seven, first round, but because it's three legs a set, it's difficult, it's pressure, every set's pressure. One mistake, and you can be two sets behind, then you're in trouble then.
Look, if it's not going well at the start, and it's a fast format, and you realise, boy, I'm a few sets down here, the more you try,
it gets worse. It gets worse. You say, please hit a double, please hit in your edge, you know? When you're missing doubles as well, that's even worse. When you've got a chance to win a set and you miss, then the other guy goes out, you think, I should have got that. But you can't think about that. You've got to carry on playing your normal game and see if you can get over that bit of a hurdle, as they call it.
Paul Lim, John Pard, and he whispered within the...
Paul Lim, he has a soft tick he plays in Japan, so he's very competitive all the time, and still to... John Pard, I don't know how he's playing. They said he's been in a couple of in the PDC. I don't know, I haven't seen him play for a long while, but he, obviously twice world champion. He's got to be some sort of player. Still, he wouldn't come up if he couldn't play darts.
Exactly.
I'm sure.
His CV is terrific, but I'm just suggesting that, you know, sometimes when you want it so much, you get here and the atmosphere is building and, you know.
You want your mummy then. But John Pott, obviously, he's used to the pressure. Paul Lim's been doing it, I don't know, he's 68 years, 50 years, I think he's been playing, so he knows the score. It'd be quite an interesting game.
You mentioned before about Phil Taylor, and when he left the Circus Tavern, he did say, I'm not going to put myself through that again.
Yeah.
So I'm assuming he will have gone away and put a lot of work in, because otherwise, the point of making can't be close to what you were. It's Phil absolutely dominated for two decades, but he's not the sort that's going to come here and just be... give his second best game.
I was surprised that he didn't put himself out more in the seniors world. He didn't play at all well. This time, I think he will. He ain't going to get caught out like that again.
Well, we will see. Phil Taylor plays later tonight. Right, let's get going. On the stage, ready to introduce the players. Paul Starr.
Welcome to the party, ladies and gentlemen. We are live at the Lakeside.
It's a stage where legends played in darts and history was made. It's the Jennings Bet World Seniors Darts Masters. And a very warm welcome to all our viewers joining us around the world. We are ready. The players are ready. And it's tungsten time! And now from Singapore, a nine-dart legend who's appeared in 26 world championships over five decades. He is the Singapore Slinger. He is Paul Lim! Now from Oshawa in Canada, he is a three times champion of the world. Ladies and gentlemen, he is Darth Maple. He is John Paul.
Well, after opening the scrapbook of sentiment at the Circus Tavern in February for the first ever Seniors Darts World Championship, the page turns to another of the sport's spiritual homes as the walk down Darts' memory lane leads us to Lakeside here in Surrey, for many the home of World Darts. And it is two Lakeside legends to cut the ribbon on this historic hall's newest tournament. As the only man to a 9-darter at the World Championship here, Paul Lim takes on a man who ruled the world in this place as he meets John Part in the opening match of the first ever World Seniors Masters. The prize, a meeting with the great Phil Taylor at the end of this evening. The format here on Frimley Green will be familiar to those who watch the old World Masters events. It's short, sharp sets. First to two legs wins a set. And in these opening rounds, first to four sets wins the match. Chris Murphy guiding you through the action with a man who knows what it's like to win on this famous stage. Good evening, Mark Webster.
Yeah, thank you, Chris. And what a way to open up as well. So much history between these two players. John Part, still playing on the CDC tour. Paul Lim, still playing at a very high level. Was in the World Championship last year. He'll be back at the World Cup in a few weeks' time with his namesake, Harith Lim, but the prize is a matchup with the 16-time world champion, Phil Taylor. There'll be some nerves there, first match of the event. John Part was disappointed in Purfleet, lost out to John Walton, underperformed. He said he's been practicing hard, but it really is a stern test for him from the word go here, because you have to say, Paul.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First set, first leg, it's Jones to throw first. Game on.
Paul Lim probably dips his hand in a lot more competitive action than John Part at the minute.
Comms director, our sounds out of sync. 60.
Steady start to the match for Paul Lim. I mentioned that appearance at the World Championship just gone. Lost out to Joe Mernon, a bit of a scrap, but he's always really competitive when it comes to the World Championship. Still got that urge as well to go in qualifiers. He went through qualifying heats for the World Cup team. He doesn't just get given that spot. Every year he goes through heats to get it. So, like I said, still got that real competitive side to him.
Yeah, good point that, Mark.
49.
Never a competitor, as is John Part. You don't become three-time world champion without being a supreme fighter. Won one of his world titles here at the Lakeside. In fact, he's got the full set, hasn't he? Circus Tavern, Lakeside, and Ali Pally. And in the run to the 1994 World Championship title, he did beat Paul Lim en route.
He was dominant in that World Championship, John, wasn't he? Dominated the final.
95. It's
the gentleman in our studio, Bobby George. Don't mind if we remind him, 6-0. And John Part went on to have a cracking career, and he still believes his career's not done. Not just at senior level.
60.
Well, the pair plugging away at the start of this opening match, a prelim. As we said, the winner to face Phil Taylor later tonight. What a carrot that is. A reminder that it's just two legs to win a set.
123.
Great effort from Paul Lim, just deflected in to the treble one. But first leg, John Part's throw is under pressure. 1-3-4, still a big ask for Paul Lim, but how's the setup from
96.
John Part? Really good last dart. And you see that first dart from John Part, that's how he likes. He likes to stack on top. So that was perfect live for the treble 19. Leaves him on a 2-darter for leg one here. And he is going to get a go at the 88.
John Newquart, 88.
We'll start on treble 20. Now the 18 segment. Oh, he's missed it completely. Big mistake from John Part in the opening 40, leg, and it can be very costly 54. In this short, snappy format.
Yeah, you've got to get the fundamentals right. Got to get that dart at the ball. How costly will it be? Well, it's catching. Paul Lim can't find the 14 segment, so he's restricting himself to, well, at least one dart. May not get that. He is going to get it. He's just checking. He's a bit hesitant here, Paul Lim. Not a lot of conviction in this 54 finish.
22.
No, just... never fancied that once he drifted into the nine. Nerves here, understandably, first match of the event.
Shuffled across from the Canadian. And he makes it count. Excellent use of the guide there from John Park to survive a bit of a scare in the opening leg. His darts in this set, and he's held on to them, but not without a bit of trouble.
Already, though, John Park be feeling better than he did in the Circus Tavern. He was chasing John Walton. He did get the third set, but he was always chasing 81. The match. If you can get out in front, it's only one leg, but if you've got the darts, hold throw. And in a blink of an eye, you can have a set on the board in this Masters format.
134. Three legs set.
Great switching from John.
Yeah, Party deserves the applause as he gets the party started here at Lakeside. We did see him at the World Seniors Championship loss
100.
To the 2000 World Master, John Boy Walton, in the last 16 there.
Yeah, that's a dart. John will switch. Yeah, I was going to... that first dart...
57.
I did see John switch the round because the first dart was above the treble 19 as well, but... John Park, not been on this stage... since 1990 to Roger Carter, but then went over to the PDC and well, we all know what he achieved there.
Good dart for Part.
80.
And if you're wondering what sort of standard to expect at these seniors events, those of you who tuned in to the World Championship will be aware that we did see a handful of 90 plus averages. Anything in that region is good, isn't it? 80s is about par for the course.
81.
Yeah, and the highest average in that last event was from Kevin Painter, above 95. We'll see Kevin later on as well, and he'll be up there, one of the favourites for the event. Still got that real competitive hunger, Kevin Painter, when he lost to Robert Thornton in the World Seniors Championship in Perth. He was gutted, still got that urge to compete, and be looking forward to seeing Kevin take on David Cameron later on.
Yeah, been wondering what he's been doing since he left office.
Well, Kevin?
No, it's not that one. No, it's another Canadian, David Cameron. More on that in the next match.
32. John Yucar,
as John Park has the chance to bring the house down.
It's a perfect first start. He'd be disappointed with that, John, you can see. He'll know. Great dart for him to work with and doesn't really round off there. Went for the treble 18, but will return to clean sweep set one.
He was peering over the shoulder there of Paul Lim, just checking what he'd got left. John Park ready to... his pocket.
97. John
but he's under pressure.
89.
Well, he's got to do what he didn't do in the previous leg and make sure he stays in the big segments that will give him a shot at the ball. He's done that. This is for set one.
44.
He wanted ball, John.
John requires 69.
In that dart there.
Paul, he's do. Precision is what he wants here. And he's got it. Well, lovely treble 15 to leave double 12.
45.
Two on the wire.
John, you were unlucky. 45.
Well thrown darts, but John Park for the opening set. Double 16. He won the opening leg. And he wins the set on double 16, and John Part, from his best, cleans through that opening set, and that's how quick it can be. Best of three legs a set, John Part strikes first, in this opening match at the World Seniors Darts Masters.
Head-to-heads are never really going to have a bearing in this tournament. Many of their previous meetings were decades ago. In fact, this is their first meeting in 20 years since Park beat Lim in the final of the Blueberry Hill Open in Missouri in 2002.
96.
John will probably remember that because he won.
He'll probably remember hitting a 9-darter against Mark Webster at the 2011 World Match Play, but he didn't win then, did he?
I was going to say, I remember the result. Good old party. John Park played in won 3 World Finals, didn't he? Beat Bobby George.
57.
Beat Phil Taylor. And beat Kirk Shepherd. He could have played his co-commentator Wayne Mardle, but he didn't hold up his end of the bargain in his semi-final, and Party cruised to world title number 3.
55.
Yeah, 4 majors for John Park. 3 of them world championships. Almost as good as your record, Mark. 75% as opposed to 100.
85.
Yeah, but I'd be inclined to prefer John's record. And that first dart...
81.
He's hit that a few times now, not really worked with it, and that... When you play John Park, I played him a few times, particularly at the Grand Slam, and I seem to draw him out all the time, and he just... You sent it a look away when he was really in top form, if that first dart was just dropping above that bottom wire.
59.
Should come down with the last dart and is
99
to once again tease us with the prospect of the biggest finish of them all.
Yeah, poor Lim, 2018, the World Championship in a 80. Second round match, almost
John Newcar, 170.
Hit a 9-dart against Gary Anderson. Beat Luke Humphries in the Worlds a couple of years ago as well, so. Still very, very competitive. That's a great setup, though, from John Park.
It wasn't that year, was it? It was that year he beat Mark Webster the round before.
We weren't talking about that.
120 on offer for the Singapore slinger. Can he sling one in tops?
100.
He's unlucky, but he's had a few darts. He's had chances. John Park. For the break early in the second set, it would be all 3 legs for the Canadian so far. Going the wrong way.
No score.
Weren't convincing those last 2 darts.
20.
So a chance now for Paul Lim to get his first leg on the board and hold his throw here.
2 tens. And still. And still.
6.
Well,
John, you require
you can hear what Paul's reaction to that dart was. That was a flyer.
John Park flying. Well, still around that same area. He needs to find the adjustment here.
He's not happy. Because his dart dipped down a bit, he's having to shuffle a bit to the right there. Saw John just shuffle across.
8.
That's... 6 Paul darts now 14. For the leg, and importantly, it would have been a break, and it was a chance for John to take early control of this opening match.
Can he use that as a guide? No, he can't.
10. John Newquart, 28.
He's appalled Lim at the moment, not happy with himself.
Scrappy, but John Park.
Game show on the first leg.
Care one bit, and that is now a 3rd consecutive leg for John Park.
Game on.
Not spectacular from Party, but he's a setup and a breakup, and he's in early charge. Man, it's first of 4 sets, but it sounds a longer format than what it is, Chris.
Yeah, it does. And it's starting to look a very long way back for old Limbo. John Park doing the dancing here.
You mentioned John Park doing a 9-darter against myself.
96.
He's three darts in here. But importantly, he's opened up with a max. That could, oh, lucky, that could give him a two-set lead, and he's well on his way here, John Part.
Yeah, excellent stuff from the 55-year-old Canadian. I mentioned all those world championship titles, but this tournament is a nod to the old World Masters. Never really had success in that.
125.
John Part played 10 successive World Masters tournaments between 93 and 02. His best was to reach the last 16 twice.
Yeah, and that's surprising. It's probably a stat that John Part will be well aware of.
57.
He prides himself on performing on the big stages and hasn't managed to do it at the World Masters, but so far he's doing okay here.
We're halfway to the last 16 if double 18 goes in. Or double 9.
78.
He will be back.
Best leg of the match so far. He's just got to finish it off. There was darts for potential 11 and 12 dart leg, but John Part will return. But decisions to make. He has missed a few darts at doubles. And Paul Lim just looking to apply a bit of pressure, but for four consecutive legs and a two-set lead, John Part will have three darts at double nine.
John Part 18.
And in it goes. It's excellent stuff from John Part. He's raced through four successive legs to take the first two sets in the first match of the first ever World Senior Darts Masters, and Party is getting the party started here at the Lakeside, where he leads Paul Lim by 2-0. Welcome back to the action here at the first ever World Senior Darts Masters, where Paul Lim has got a lot of work to do. He might need that extra bit of practice after losing the first four legs and therefore the first two sets to the great John Part, who is loving life back at the Lakeside. There have been moments, chances for Paul Lim. He hasn't all been one-way traffic, but Part halfway to setting up a repeat meet with Phil the Power Taylor.
Plenty for Paul Lim to ponder, but he can take a bit of comfort in how quick those sets went is how quick he could turn this match around. He's had chances. John Part, though, a lot more clinical, and look at the smile on his face. He looks comfortable, John. He was looking more and more comfortable as the game went on and was really clinical in the final leg of that second set. And halfway. First match of the night. And the winner of this will be in the last match of the night. And sandwiched in between that, we've got Kevin Painter against David Cameron. And Wayne Jones against Roland Shelton.
Yeah, nice evening's entertainment on offer. And a double dose of darts tomorrow. And again on Sunday, finals day, it will be trophy time. Will Robert Thornton add another to the set? The first ever World Seniors champion who picked up the big prize at the Circus Tavern. Great start for John Part. Paul Lim, as Mark said though, can take heart from the fact that he was...
First head, first leg, it's John to throw first. Game
left
on
doubles in the majority of those legs.
Just very hesitant though, wasn't he? We were just talking off air, Chris. I think he was a lot more methodical when he was at the business end of a leg than
99.
In the middle of it. And John Parr will take a lot of encouragement from the hesitancy from Paul Lim, but he's got to be careful. Paul Lim loses this set and he's on the brink.
139.
Good start attacking from the off, really. Important start, you feel, for Paul Lim, just to give himself that extra bit of edge at the start of set three.
99. Yeah,
definitely. I think he needs a comfortable leg, doesn't he? He just needs to get ahead of John Part because he's not convinced at the back end. And every mistake he made, he got punished. in those opening two sets.
He's a man, as they all are, a great experience. 96. He's played in 26 World Championships, 12 BDO, 14 PDC. And he has won titles in his 60s, hasn't he, Paul Lim, and the Asian Tour. Those qualifiers you mentioned to get in things like the World Cup. Didn't go well for him at the Circus Tavern, lost in a prelim to the Badger, Dave Prinz.
Yeah, but still so hungry to compete. And I'm indebted to
96.
Him as well. Got me a job as a commentator, Paul Lim. But to be fair, that atmosphere when I played that night, they really took to Paul Lim.
60.
Paul, I'm not just saying it was one of the best performances I've seen from him. He averaged at 990s. I know you don't believe me, but he did. He was unreal.
Well, you should know, you had a front row seat.
Did. Lim. I still wake up in hot sweats hearing that name.
Well, it is the hot start that he needed.
134.
Excellent switching there to leave himself on double 18 after just a dozen darts.
This is just what we said, a leg where he knows that he's got a bit of margin for error on the double. In all likelihood, John is going to find it hard to take out the 1-4-2.
That's better on the first leg.
Paul Lim, at the fifth time of asking, has registered a leg on the board. Importantly, it was a break of the John Part dart. So, I said at the beginning of this set, it can turn around like that in best of three legs in a set. Paul Lim throwing to half the deficit in terms of set score.
And he is the man who hit the best leg at this venue in a World Championship.
60.
Back in 1990, remains the only player to have hit a nine-darter at the Lakeside World Championship. The last 16 win over Jack McKenna. In fact, when he arrived, he was talking to Helen, and he said he hasn't been here since.
60. But
he actually played in three more tournaments after that at the Lakeside. I suppose it all just blends into one, doesn't it, the older you get? Does it, Mark?
Steady. The amount of darts Paul Lim's played. He's got to switch here. Hanging precariously. This is a good response from Paul Lim. Giving John something to think about for the first time in the match.
100.
It's good to see John Park came in to see us earlier, Chris, when they said to him, John, you're supposed to be doing the bull at 6 o'clock. John replied with, what time is it now? It was 6:05. Casual John Part, always the way.
Yeah, then went and won the ball.
100.
Wouldn't have had it if I was Paul Lim. I would have said, no, he's got to be disqualified. But it was us that were keeping him chatting.
There we are, John using that 100. Stacking dart again there. And the standard's lifting now. Paul Lim just creeping into the 80 averages. John getting up towards 78.
Just checking the score there, 63. Conveyed to him by the ace official, Paul Hinks, who's been one of the unsung heroes of this sport over the years.
Another one, another two treble visit here. And John, you feel he needs another one.
99.
Yeah, and again, he's on 1-4-2. That's what he's on when Paul was on a finish in the previous leg.
Can't finish now. Party will have a pop at the 1-4-2.
80.
Good rescue dart from Paul Lim to lead top, but John Part will start on treble 20 and in all likelihood will stay there if he finds the first one. He can't find it, so he's just going to have to lay it, but Paul has missed a lot of doubles in this match.
78.
And again, Paul, a good rescue dart from John, but Paul Lim for the third set.
Not happy. Not happy at all, Paul Lim.
35. John Newcastle, 64.
Big chance. And that was to really race away with set three. John Parr. These were the finishes. Well, he's aimed in that region. Treble 16, treble 8. Either one will do. That's brilliant.
Second leg.
And John Parr. levels up Philip the set Jones and gets the throw now to throw for the three-set lead. So the revival was short-lived for Paul Lim. He's going to have to find a break, otherwise he's going three sets to nil down. And John Parr, as I said, even with that little blip, still looked comfortable, still looked more relaxed than he looked throughout the whole tie against John Walton in Perth late in February.
Yeah, he's a man who enjoys opportunities like that. The eternal darting opportunist, wasn't he, John Parr, back in his day?
Yeah, he was...
46.
He was always there to punish opponents. He had the knack, didn't he, of taking out those shots we saw, 64. The ones that can sometimes be awkward, but John Parr...
99.
Made it look easy in his day, and he made it look easy in that previous leg, and he's on his way to a three-set lead.
Yeah, intercostals crushed with finishes like that. Now, this leg could be massive.
76.
And Paul Lim has been far too careless at the back end of legs. And he's been missing. When he missed doubled, when we had that reaction, he was missing by a fair way, really. They weren't convincing. Tops, tens, and fives. There's some wayward ones at tens. But if he can somehow pinch this leg, it's all back on throw. This is a big leg, particularly for Paul Lim.
And he knows it. That's why the little 81. Team talk. All good fun.
That you can see, Paul, he sort of stretched that arm out. You'll see behind John Parr occasionally, he'll have that
22.
Sort of phantom dart throw, but it's not happening. And John Parr is in a really comfortable position, six, possibly nine, at 188 to put himself in a 58. Great position and set up that tie with Phil Taylor to conclude the evening.
He'll relish that, won't he, as well, John Parr. As he'll take centre stage one more time.
He'll look forward to that. Towards the end of his career in the World Championship, he was seeded 32 and had a chance to set up a tie with Bill Taylor. He really relished that, and he was under the weather and lost to Per Larsson. So he'd love a crack at Phil Taylor here tonight on the Lakeside stage.
He'll have a crack at the ball.
105. Paul Newcastle
wasn't far away from it. Probabilities say he shouldn't have gone for it. Has to waste a dart when he comes back to leave a double.
Yeah, this is in the balance now. And we saw John Parr deviate from the big segment
96. John Newcastle
earlier on
25.
In the match when he needed an 18 for ball. It'll be a 9. Got that part done. And he gets that part done, and it is John Parr. That is three sets to nil up. He's one set away from booking a place in the next round. And we just got a slight glimpse of two of our other competitors in this event. Trina Gulliver, Lisa Ashton, they'll be in action throughout the weekend.
Yeah, Trina Gulliver, the competitor with the most World Masters titles to her name. Well, it might well be 4-0 to John Parr this match. It won't tell the story of the match.
100.
But he's done what John Parr used to do. Demonic doubling in the last couple of legs from Parr. Taking out that. That's 64, 58. And then sneaking it into the bottom of the double eight.
He's looked comfortable, John. Like I said, he had that, that little wobble, the one leg that Paul Lim won, but set play, leg play, it all
96.
Looks good in favour of John Parr. He's just got to finish the job. Doesn't want to get embroiled here, get this done, particularly knowing that he's got another game tonight. If he wins,
96.
No rest. So if he can get it done in the minimum amount of time, A real good start to the event for John.
He had a 13 darter to win the second set, completing the run of four on the spin. Lim responded with a 14 to get his first on the board, but then Park
45
has won the last two.
Paul Rukal, 100.
And Paul Lim really needs to put himself in the position here. He's got a great chance to get the first leg of set four.
Game show, the first leg.
Best leg of the match for Paul Lim. And it's a set that he has to win, particularly it's on his darts. Comeback's got to start somewhere, and it never goes to pattern, but he only needs one break of throw, and he can level the match at three sets. It never goes like that, but that's how he's got to break it down. Has to win this set, make his move in the next set, and just try and make John Park have a few doubts, because at the minute, John Park will be fairly relaxed with the situation.
60.
So much jeopardy in this format, isn't there? And we've seen it play out in this match.
99.
And many more modern darts tournaments. In set play, it's first to three. And it makes a big difference, doesn't it?
It does, because you win that opening leg, you've
got a bit of bounce,
you know you're almost there. You lose that opening leg, I've almost lost the first set, and it's literally does turn the game on one leg.
127.
Brilliant recovery from John Park. Came down the bottom of the board, hoping for the 19 segment to leave him on a finish, but good tidy on the couple of treble 20s.
Just keeping up the heat.
123.
Good response from Paul, but John Park wins this leg. He's a leg away from the match. And all the pressure will be on Lim.
97.
Speaking of limbs. Well, Park's got the opportunity to get to that position, to leave Paul Lim standing directly over the trapdoor.
99, John requires 79.
To go one away. And he's been pretty neat and tidy at the back end of the legs. That is very neat and tidy. And that is John Park, one leg away. Over to you, Paul Lim.
Game on.
He knows it's a massive leg, but the opening visit, will it offer encouragement for John Park to get the job done here? Got to find at least one treble, you feel.
Well, the nice two darters in this match have been excellent from John Park.
45.
He's taken out 48, 45, 64, 25, and then that 79.
And that was just a no-nonsense 79, wasn't it?
81.
John Powell expected another treble after the way that one landed in the treble 20, but can Paul Lim respond?
A quick reminder following this, Kevin Painter against David Cameron. 81. What a performance Painter put in at the Circus Tavern to send the power packing. Will we see a different Phil Taylor tonight and this weekend, Mark?
Well, yeah, definitely. He will be better. He's been practicing. I played an exhibition with him last week. He looked a lot better. He's a lot more confident. Said he'd been practicing. Admitted to me as well that he was nervous in Purfleet. He was edgy against Peter Manley in the game he won, but was outplayed by Kevin. And I think particularly getting beat so easily by Kevin Painter will hurt him. But
95.
Credit Kevin. He was one of the stories of the tournament. Obviously, Robert Thornton aside, I thought Kevin was excellent.
Yeah, well, he might well look at the scoreline, assuming Party goes on to win this leg, and see that John Park has won 4-0, but if he's watched the match,
50
you have to say not too much to make him nervous.
No, but he know all too well that he drops his level, and this is about the level Phil was playing at in the low 80s, so he won't take anything for granted, and it's not John Park yet.
41.
Well, it's been a case of John Part making the most of Paul Lim's mistakes, but Paul Lim not doing the same to John Part.
Yeah, definitely. Paul Lim far too hesitant at the back end of legs, too many wayward darts, and particularly at doubles as well. And see, that's a perfect first dart. Can he work with it? And again, that's a flyer.
99.
But still, you'd say just about makes in favour of the leg. All about this visit. If John can get a two treble visit, then Lim's really under it.
Just to make sure he leaves something
59.
Checkoutable.
Paul Lepar, 140.
It would be a wonderful way to win the match. And he will get a go for some fireworks.
41.
Ah.
Johnny McCarr, 164.
Not just in the treble, but he's drifted in to the one. We'll only get one dart minimum at a double if he returns. What a way to finish the job this would be. John Part for the match.
Yay, and Part has pinned it.
The match. John Part.
Magical from John Part. An incredible 164 checkout. Landed against Lim to complete a whitewash win. What a moment that is in the very first match. 164 from John Part.
And ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Paul Lim. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you. Oh!
Oh, I'm over here.
What a way to finish the game.
Yeah, it was a very hard match. We spent the whole Seniors World Championship basically together watching every single dart thrown, because we were a little worried about the COVID restrictions flying home. So we were together, and he's been a pal for like three decades, and to have to play each other here was really tough, especially after that experience. But, you know, I don't think he got to his best at all, but we kind of ground out a standard that was decent enough. And I think I'm very happy to get that finish at the end, of course. You know, a signature finish to end a match is always cool. So I like that. But, I think he deserves that send-off, really. And not in a bad way, but a good way. You know, don't go out because I'm hitting a double one or something. Go out because I hit a 164. So, Paul, I hope you're at the next one, and we get another chance maybe. But I don't want to play, except if it's a final. That's it. That's the only one.
You can tell he's a pundit now, can't you? Anyway, you said at the start of it, you were kind of slogging away a little bit. We did not see the famous Part snarl. That didn't appear tonight. Not yet.
I can't snarl against Paul too much. I got one out somewhere along the way, the third or fourth set, when I realized it was in my control and that I should take it and I should put it away. And I was still a little bit lax and hitting a lot of no treble turns in the big singles, but still, that's not going to do much most times. So, and he brought his game up after the break. He came in and he threw some steady, good darts, and he asked questions of me, and at least I just barely had some answers. So I'm very thrilled, because if it went further, deeper into the match, I mean, I don't know. I don't know if I win it. I really don't.
Well, the scoreline's very flattering.
It is. It is very flattering.
You afforded yourself a wry smile when the crowd booed you for missing your fifth dart for a nine dart
finish.
Yeah,
the fifth dart, yeah.
Badge of honor,
though. Boo!
Yeah, maybe I'll fix it later tonight, you know? You know?
I'm not going to keep you long, because you are back.
I just, I'll be a lot more comfortable later, because I don't like Phil at all. That's a lie, but not as much as Paul. I mean, Paul's the most lovable guy on earth. Come on.
That's great. Well, look, John, we will let you go, because you are back here later on tonight on stage playing Phil Taylor. So
yes.
For the meantime, whatever you wish to do, relax or get back
on the
practice board. Ladies and gentlemen, John Part.
Thank you.
Finishing with a 164 checkout. We will see him again later. Ladies and gentlemen, time for a break. Kevin Painter, David Cameron on this stage. We will see you back here in a few minutes' time.
A
Welcome back to the Lakeside Country Club. The Seniors Darts Masters is underway. Bobby George has been waving to his fans from his balcony positions like he's in his royal box. This has been terrific. Tell you what, John Parr, what a way to finish that match, 1-6-4. That was great.
Well, the thing, Paul him had his chances, but he wasn't playing at all well.
No.
His darts were dropping below the treble 20. He had wild ones, you know, he just wasn't in it. But John Parr, steady, played pretty well, but the 1-6-4, lovely jubbly, isn't it?
What a contrast, because John was finishing very nicely, then he gets the 1-6-4, and he's racing away with it. And you could see Paul, he's throwing his arm around, and he could talk it to himself. To me, that just showed, as you've always said, sort of, when they go in, they go in. And sometimes they can do a mile away, can't they?
Well, three legs set. That's the dodgy bit.
It's quick, isn't it?
It's quick, you know. All of a sudden, you can do two sets down, you're back in trouble, like I said earlier. So, it's a shame. I thought Paul Lim would have played a bit better than that, to be honest with you.
Congratulations to John Parr.
Yeah.
And now, he goes away for a little while, and he comes back to play Phil Taylor. I think they've played in five finals against each other down the years, major finals. And I think John has won one and lost one world championship final against Phil. But look, I'm sure they've played each other many times down the years. Although I've no idea what the head-to-head is, but no one's got a decent head-to-head against Phil, I would imagine, down the years.
Well, no, obviously Phil was the captain of the ship, wasn't he, for years. But Phil Taylor, he's not going to be easy as Paul Lim, I don't think so. And I would think Party would have to up his game a little bit more.
Yeah, this is a different kettle of fish. Okay, so Phil Taylor against John Parr later tonight. That's going to be exciting for this crowd and everybody watching at home. Kevin Painter against David Cameron. What do you reckon?
Well, I don't know. David Cameron, I've heard his name. I think he played in a BDO championship sometime. I'm not that name, not the Prime Minister. I'm not that thick.
No. I've heard the name before as well, by the way. I have heard the name before.
Oh, dear. But Kevin Painter, he plays steady darts. Yeah. In the seniors' world, he played pretty good. He was steady, wasn't he? So I can't really talk about David Cameron, because I don't really know him, to be honest with you.
I'm told he's very good on number 10s. Sorry. Okay, let's get going. Second match, back to Paul Starr.
Welcome back to the party, ladies and gentlemen. We are live at the Lakeside! It's a stage where legends played in darts and history was made. It's the Jennings Bet World Seniors Darts Masters, and we are ready. The players are ready, and it's tungsten time! And now from Halifax, Nova Scotia, Canada. He's a Jennings Bet World Seniors Masters qualifier. He's Excalibur. He is David Cameron! And now from Essex, England, he's a former world finalist, he's a former players champion, and he is the artist, he is Kevin Painter!
Be
We'll follow that, gentlemen. A party piece from John Park, the 164 checkout to win 4-0 against Paul Lim. And Party will be back at the party. A meeting with Phil Taylor in the last match of tonight here at the Lakeside. And match two of this nostalgic night sees another Canadian competitor take centre stage, this time in the form of David Cameron, who meets Arrows artist Kevin Painter, the man who accounted for Taylor in his run to the semi-finals at the World Seniors Championship. David Cameron from Canada now completes the set of having played on this Lakeside stage under three different organisations. BDO, WDF and now the World Seniors Dart Tour goes up against the 2011 Players Champion, Kevin Painter. Remember that one, Mark? Mark?
Sorry, what? I drifted off there. Good to see Kevin. Sporting a naughty little pair of shoes there, but in all seriousness, Kevin Painter, we talked about having that competitive edge.
It's David to throw first.
It will never leave Kevin Painter. He's been playing on the live league. If he can get through this game, he's set up a rematch of that semi-final with Robert Thornton, but a real competitor is Kevin. Heart on his sleeve and one again to watch. And like I said, Thornton aside, I thought he was the story of the inaugural World Seniors World Championship in Purfleet.
Yeah, many would see that as a bit of a annoying draw, wouldn't they? Get past David Cameron and it's Robert Thornton. But Painter will fancy that. He'll want that chance for revenge.
100.
Has to get past the 52-year-old from Fall River in Nova Scotia first.
Yeah, this is a tough assignment for Kevin.
45.
David Cameron is off to the US Masters next week. He's one of the eight qualifiers. Takes on the eight from the PDC. So, a bit of jetting around for David Cameron, but
100.
Definitely got the game.
Yeah, he won the qualifier to get to this tournament, in fact, just 5 days after a round one defeat 60. On this very stage at the WDF World Championship when he was whipped by the whippet, Ian Jones. Went to the qualifiers in Reading and booked his spot along with another
55.
Jones, Wayne Jones.
Yeah, Wayne Jones for me is a serious contender for this. Again, like Kevin, it's not
44.
Not the same sort of attitude in terms of the way they approach the game, but both really got that hunger to win. Kevin Painter, when you play him, will really let you know when you're involved in a game. Wayne Jones, well, a lot more subdued. 40.
David Ducroix, 56.
So for the first leg, and it's a healthy lead for David Cameron in this one.
36.
Painter not mixing it yet.
No. Nervy one, but a good leg from David Cameron. Got to finish it off, though. Kevin Painter. Don't be panicking just
55.
Yet.
55. David Ducroix, 20.
Cameron to strike first. Got to be careful here. Does strike first, and David Cameron with a comfortable hold and throw.
Second leg is Kevin to throw first.
Strikes first in this second match here of four. Wayne Jones, Roland Shelton, Phil Taylor, and John Parsell to come.
100.
They mentioned those qualifiers. Do spare a thought for Burnley's Robert Rickwood, who lost 6-5 to Cameron in the semi-final 66. On the first day of the qualifiers, and then on the next day lost 6-4 to Wayne Jones in the final. Two qualifiers held.
99.
Those two coming through. Then Richie Houston, the other man, down as a qualifier. He gets here having topped the World Series Darts Tour order of merit. There is a full tour, so if you are sat at home at over 50,
99.
And think that you can mix it and maybe get to the Lakeside stage or the Circus Tavern or the Bonus Arena in Hull, where we'll play the World Match Play later on this year, then head to the World Seniors 92. Website and put your money where your mouth is.
Yeah, definitely worth a go, and in 22 years' time when I'm eligible, I'll be certainly having a crack at it. So many rewards at the 85. Senior level of darts now.
I thought darts players were supposed to be good at maths.
Yeah, sorry, 24. Did I say 22? 24, just come off the development tour, so obviously the next step.
A good response from Kevin Painter, having been battered in the opening leg.
81, Kevin Painter's been 72.
Round long enough to know that games aren't won and lost in the opening leg. Can
32.
Will luck be on Kevin's side like it was in 2011 in Doncaster? His one and only major title in the PDC.
Well, we saw a 164 from John Part.
But
we don't see the 170. It was threatened by David Cameron.
Kevin to level up. Good down, Kevin. Good leg.
Kevin
And like in the first match, the first set goes to the deciding leg. John Part raced through the first two sets without reply.
80.
Those averages you see on your screen there, by the way, if you wondered why such a big jump from just one dart at tops from Painter there, they reset at the end 55. Of each leg. It doesn't change after every throw.
Slender advantage for David Cameron in this deciding leg of set one.
45.
And like we've already said, won't get any easier. Robert Thornton awaits, but neither player we'll be looking that far ahead just
55.
Yet.
Yeah, we know Painter could be a danger at the tournament, and some of his fans have come to give him their backing. But Cameron can certainly be a danger for Painter. Mentioned that win over Rickwood in the qualifier, but perhaps his most impressive victory was in the final when he beat Paul Hogan 6-0. No mean feat.
Oh, Paul Hogan. He cropped up particularly at the UK Open in the last few years, hasn't he? He had those pictures against Gary Anderson, Adrian Lewis. He's a player that you feel if he applied himself a little bit more, would have had more success. But Paul Hogan, I'm sure at some point we'll see
100
on the Will Senior stage.
Yeah, one of many big names who's testing himself on the tour. Chris Mason, another, he won a precursor to those qualifiers, but didn't manage to make it to the main show.
It'll be good to see Mace up there, won't it? Keep plodding away.
Now look at Richie House, and he's managed to arguably 59. Become a bigger name in seniors darts than he ever was on the main tour.
What a shot this would be from Kevin. Tops for set one, and we will see this a lot from Kevin. He likes to just steady himself, particularly on a big moment like this.
Game
that is a brilliant dart from Kevin Painter. Look at the emotion. And Painter strikes first. It's a leg against the darts. It's a set against the darts. We've seen a 164 from John Parr in the opening match, but that 151 from Kevin Painter gives him game the early on. Advantage in the second match of the evening.
Well, you would have seen John Part's party piece, and now the artist has produced a masterpiece.
58.
A wonderful 151 to seal the set. And we saw the damage losing that opening set did to Paul Lim. Never really recovered. Well, it was the first two sets really that did the damage, but getting a break as early as possible is really important.
Yeah. Kevin Painter just reminding everyone that
99.
Still got that quality, and he's got a throw that's never really broken down. It's changed slightly, but it's the same steady action for Kevin throughout his career.
58.
Yeah, this tournament, a nod to the World Masters. These short, sharp sets. Kevin Painter played in nine 100. Successive World Masters between 1993 and 2001, reaching the quarterfinals in his last, where he lost to the late, great Andy Fordham.
140.
Good stacking from David Cameron. He's got the feeling it's going to be a really close game, this one already. May come down to the odd mistake or a big moment that we've already seen from Kevin Painter. And a great switch again from Kevin Painter, who, like you said, who got to the semi-finals, Richard Antonio, O'Shea, Wayne Warren, Phil Taylor, and eventually to Robert Thornton. That is some draw.
Yeah, well, you said it had the makings of a good game, and that first match against Tony O'Shea is easily forgotten. He went to a tie-break brilliant game of darts. 54.
David McCall, 145.
No such problems in the next round. Won every leg without reply against Wayne Warren.
Kevin, you require 56.
16 then. Well, it was a bit close to the double for comfort. Wouldn't really have mattered. Too far away from the double 41. For comfort. And Cameron gets the chance 89. To pick his pocket.
Yeah, just a little bit messy now because Kevin's got to return and split 15 if he gets the chance. Cameron for tops. Tops, double five.
79. Well,
double five Kevin is what he hit to in his 15. Only leg. He couldn't find it there, but this ain't a simple one for Kevin. Double four.
11. David, you require 10.
Well, he said it wouldn't be easy. It is proving tough going. Game Painter after that line. Brilliant 1-5-1. Has struggled.
Second leg is David to throw first.
Cameron breaks. And could be about to put this match back on throw.
Yeah, and drifting into the double five is what caused Kevin the problems there. And David Cameron makes the perfect start and is looking to level up this match at one apiece.
76.
We saw John Part open a leg with a 180, hit another treble 20, and then got booed for missing the fifth. Much to his amusement.
100.
It's looking like we're heading to one set apiece, and Kevin Painter from looking so comfortable.
44.
Flipped his lines in the opening leg. And it looks like we're heading in at one set apiece.
85.
Well, he'll know that David Cameron is just as capable of, as you put it, fluffing his lines as Painter is himself, and will want to try and apply as much
59.
Pressure as possible.
David Yukar, 136.
It's just gone missing since that magical moment.
96. Just having time to lay up the 136, and it was all one-way traffic in that opening match. It's not going to be here. David Cameron will surely level up this match at one set apiece. Painter 84. Way back.
David
Cameron
40.
To finish the job in set two.
David Cameron locked out of 30. Number 10. And he hits a 10. To leave that double five again, it's been a bit of a main character in this match, 60. Double five.
David, you require 10.
It's been his go-to double. Is he going to finish set two on it? It's getting a bit scrappy here. Double two. And this is getting messy. And even Kevin on 178 can't finish. But David Cameron has no wriggle room on double one.
It's the, in a way, the previous leg. Like, switched around.
138.
A roll reversal.
You require two.
Will Painter be allowed back? Or can Cameron clinch it?
No score.
There's the answer.
Kevin, you require 40.
I called it. And Kevin Painter knew as well. When he hit that 18, there was a roar because he knew how awkward double one is. We all know how awkward double one is. You've had plenty of practice on it, Chris. And Kevin Painter levels up errors in this set. And it's probably a fair scoreline that we go to the deciding leg. They've gone the wrong way round, but Kevin Painter now has the darts for a two-set lead.
They're already a big leg in the match. A few drifters from Kevin Painter. Even the dart in top was way off to the left, wasn't it? From the artist there, having in the previous leg actually drifted into the double five.
He's stuttering in this set, Kevin,
96.
Isn't he? It's going to be a scrappy one for whoever gets there. Both legs gone against the darts. It's better from Kevin.
Yeah, no danger of drifting here.
108!
He's on song.
140.
Good response from David Cameron. Credit to him. Well, you made a real hash of a leg, and your opponent fires in a 180. But Cameron hit a 180 in the previous leg, but this is edgy.
Well,
he's made sure of a finish now, Kevin Painter. He might have to pull off something special to win a set again. He landed a 1-5-1 to win the opening set. He might well have to take out this 1-2-3.
145.
There's the pressure.
Kevin Yukar, 123.
Two data for David Cameron. Painter will start at the bottom of the board. 16. Bullseye. What a shot this would be.
98. David Yukar, 41.
That close to doubling his lead in this match, Kevin Painter. And now Cameron wants tops to level, wants tens to level. And he can't go out either.
Kevin Yukar, 25.
He may have to rethink his route because tops and tens are not a favourite of David Cameron. But Kevin has split 25 earlier and he went the nine route. He's not electing this time. Double four. Big dart for Kevin.
17.
And he goes the wrong side. It's getting nervy. David, it's been a nervy set 10. From start to finish.
That double five again, right on the wire. Is it too close? No, he's managed to nudge it in and nudge himself level in this match. There have been some nerves, a moment of magic when Painter cleaned up the 1-5-1 to win set one, but Cameron levels and it is one set apiece. Welcome back to the inaugural World Seniors Darts Masters, where Kevin Painter and David Cameron are tied at one set apiece. The artist producing a wonderful 1-5-1 checkout to win the opening set, but it all got a little bit messy in the second, and Cameron managed to sneak it to level up. It is two legs to win a set and four sets to win the match as the players are ready to return to the stage to fight it out to the end now and see which one of the pair progresses to take on the World Seniors Darts champion Robert Thornton in the last 16. Mark, what will they have been doing in the break? Because Kevin Painter will know that he could have been halfway home by now.
It'll definitely be David Cameron feeling a lot more relieved and a lot more satisfied with the scoreline. It's 1-1, it's level, but the circumstances in which that set slipped away from Kevin will hurt, because he stole the second leg and had the chance to throw for it and had darts to win the set, three in fact, but couldn't get it done. So David Cameron, but David Cameron probably just on the balance of play deserves to be level. Just needs to tidy up his finishing. Double tops and double ten. You just don't fancy him, Chris, do you?
It could be a good night for Canada, couldn't it? If he can tidy that up. John Part already through. David Cameron looking to join him. A man who once won the WDF World Cup pairs with Jeff Smith.
First set, first leg, it's TV to throw first. Game on.
Speaking of pairs, Jeff Smith will be at the World Cup next month along with Matt Campbell, a finalist on tour this year, and that's a real dark horse of a team. Don't write off them two to make an impact in the World Cup.
140.
Plenty of classy Canadians. Well, which one will it go pear-shaped for here? Well, they both come out with some authority. 140 for Cameron. Painter responds with a maximum, his second of the match.
Both players just going to settle now. They've 19. Both got a set. There's both been some nervy moments. There's both been some moments of quality, but both have had moments of quality, I should say.
140.
It's good. Good from both. Kevin, 181 after six darts. Not too shabby for David either.
It's his first appearance at Lakeside, would you believe, Kevin Painter, for 21 years. He's played 38 matches on that stage before this one, winning 23 of them, 54. Twice a World Championship quarter-finalist at this venue.
He's had some tough draws, had some cushy draws. He got the luxury of playing Andy Jenkins in one of his first round matches once.
Kevin, you were about 127.
That was as good as a banker on that Lakeside stage.
95. David Urquhart, 52.
This is a banker for Cameron. Nothing really has been when he's left tops, so he's, well, he's almost bust to be fair, but he gets a dart, a different double.
44.
Did that put him off?
Kevin Urquhart, well, I was just going to say, I think it put Kevin off earlier as well. On the 16 for tops, he went in the double, and there was the same reaction. He went in double five, and game never really reset himself, Kevin, on that Kevin occasion. Pizza. David in there, and it's Kevin second who makes Kevin the early break. First.
Game on.
Well, it's a bit of a topsy-turvy encounter, this one.
There's a bit more force in the Kevin Painter throw now, isn't it?
Yeah, he's having it now. Kevin Painter doesn't want to drag himself into drama like he did when he met Tony O'Shea at the Circus Tavern.
No, and it was a game that you felt was there for Kevin to win, wasn't it? And he really kicked himself, but...
96.
Just get the job done with a minimum of fuss. Breaks a thrower. Guaranteeing nothing here.
Well, this one of four prelim matches. One has been played, of course. Paul Lim against John Park. The third will follow this. Roland Scholten against Wayne Jones. The other 95. Is Terry Jenkins against Richie Howson tomorrow.
And these are a couple of really brutal draws, aren't they? Kevin Painter, David Cameron. I said that. Terry Jenkins, Richie Howson. A real close encounter. David Cameron finds a match and said, breaks a throw and not being followed up.
60.
A chance for an 11 dart leg for the Canadian.
Double four then.
52.
Well, it seems like it doesn't matter which double he leaves, Mark. He can't hit any of them.
No, well, double five he can. He needs a bit too much time at the end of the leg, and he may not get any more time here. Kevin just thinking his route. Tops. He's had a 1-5-1 to win set one. And that is a 1-10 to win set three, and that's what it means. And Kevin Painter blitzes his way through set three.
First leg is Kevin first.
Turn on the heel because he's got the darts in this fourth set. Brilliant from Kevin. There we see.
Yeah, and he's strutting as well now, isn't he, Kevin Painter? Commanding that stage the way only he can.
26.
What was that, Chris?
Well, he was when I said it. Now he's sulking.
Like only
he can.
Kevin can. How's your luck?
135.
Kevin Painter. A sign of a smile there, surely not.
60.
Yeah, often the Painter smirk is one of irony. It's him against the world in his view, isn't it?
121.
The man who came close, of course, to being king of the world. Lost in a sudden death leg to Phil Taylor in the World Championship.
160.
When I watch reruns of that, I'm still convinced Kevin's going to win. He led throughout. He had to see 4-1 up, 5-2 up, and then he trailed 6-5, got himself back in it. It was just not meant 60. To be for Kevin that night.
Yeah, that was back in 2004 at the Circus Tavern, where he exercised some of those demons with victory over the power at the first ever World Seniors Championship in February.
He caused a bit of a stir by beating Phil Taylor in the Grand Prix in a first round game as well, but generally, you don't see Kevin Payne to beat Phil Taylor, so he really enjoyed that a few months ago.
Once again, it's a leg where Cameron is down to a a makeable out shot first. Should be on a double first. Will be if he stays straight and hits a single 20.
Well, that's better, really, because this is the only double he's been hitting.
80. Kevin, you require 112.
And that's gone now. And Kevin Painter, who we've just seen clean up 110, is looking for a third three-figure out shot of the match.
And there, brilliant adjustment.
96. Lucky.
But so Kevin far, you'd argue five. Kevin is just a lot more clinical. There's not a great deal in it. Look at the averages. But Kevin Painter is a lot more neat and tidy at the back end of the legs. David Cameron is leaving messy finishes. There we see again. He's making Kevin a mess of those 16. Messy finishes. And for a third consecutive leg for Painter.
Game shows him where the doubles Kevin are. Painter. Cameron is getting to doubles. He's missing them. Kevin Painter's hitting them. And there will be no more breaks in this match, but if they were, Cameron might wander over to the 59. Merchandise store and ask if he could buy some bigger doubles.
There's 140.
That'll be sold out, trust me. Sought after for dark players, but Kevin Painter has taken encouragement in the fragilities of David Cameron at the back end of the leg. So Kevin probably believes he's never out of a leg now. And we saw that with that 178, didn't we? Early on in the match.
Yeah, he knows that Cameron is culpable to miss.
100.
They didn't want to miss this. Another tungsten trip down memory lane. The legendary Lakeside. Come on, Mark, do you still get the goosebumps when you wander into the venue and reflect on your greatest glory here?
A little bit.
Let's be honest.
Yeah, I'm not trying to play it down. Not massively, no. It was a long time ago, wasn't it? So I still like coming down and looking at my picture in the back room. It's nice to know that I haven't altered.
140.
But nice to come back, but yeah, I don't really reminisce too much. Long time ago, like I said.
138.
From the 178 this time, Painter with the perfect setup. And he's making memories of his own here.
59. Yeah,
Painter laid up with a 178 earlier, and he's just starting to flex his muscles in this match, Kev. And that is the fourth set and the first bit of daylight in terms of set score. But Kevin Painter's come back from the break with four consecutive legs, and David Cameron is leaving himself a lot of work to do here.
Part through after seeing off Paul Lim in straight sets. The cake iced with that sublime 164 checkout. What a moment that was. And Kevin Painter looking to join John Parts in the field for the last 16. The first last 16 match takes place this evening. It will be Parts against Phil Taylor.
123.
It's good to see John Parts, though, back on the stage. And some real moments of magic, and you said, Chris, that 164, and Kevin's in again. Maximum number four for Kevin.
100.
Racking them up. Well, some of the standout ties from that round. And Bob Anderson will take on Keith Deller. Lisa Ashton against Tony 91. O'Shea, that really.
David Ricard, 138.
Looks a competitive one. Speaking of Keith Deller, 138.
Did he hit 138, did he? Doesn't.
He did it like this, treble 18. Yep, double 12.
I don't remember that. Game that was better.
David Cameron.
That was a lot more clinical. And he did it in a sensible pair of trousers, not those naughty red ones that we'll see Keith Deller donning tomorrow.
He's angered the artist.
123.
Wasn't far away from another maximum to add to the tally. A brilliant 138 from David Cameron. He apologised for getting it.
140.
Don't apologise to Kev, you'll get blown back from him. Credit to David Cameron. When you've missed so many doubles to take a 138. Especially when he's stopping a run of four consecutive legs against him. Still in this tight.
59.
Yeah, that's one of the 100. Interesting quirks of set play format, particularly this short set play format. Never really feel you're out of it, do you?
No, it is. You can quickly
85.
Turn. This could be 3-3 in the blink of an eye, can't it? So Kevin will play this format many a time. He'll know just how quick it can turn around. So it has to stay focused.
He had just reeled off four straight legs before that, the artist.
180! Kevin O'Brien,
interesting.
96.
180 to leave 37.
Just piling in. Well, it doesn't rattle. The aim was to rattle Kevin Payne, but that's a really good finish. He's one away. David Cameron is throwing to stay in the World Seniors Darts Masters. Painter eager to get the job done. Good last start from David Cameron.
Well, he snuck his average up to as good as 90 here, Kevin Painter. Cameron not far behind. It's a decent 60. Darting duel at the World Seniors, isn't it? This is, you'd say, a kind of B-standard game in terms of what we would expect at the World Seniors.
140.
We expected it to be a tight game, and even though the scoreline is 3-1, it's still in the balance. Could easily be 3-2 in a couple of minutes' time. Advantage, David Cameron. But the main talking point is how fragile he's been at the back end of the leg. If Kevin Painter can hang about within striking distance, 91. He'll fancy himself to get a chance.
Good visit.
Doesn't leave a finish, but they were well thrown darts from Kev. But Cameron, time with a 170. But not making massive inroads here. And 50. Bit of a desperation dart, but again, I get it.
Yeah, but he can only get one dart at the end of a combination.
45.
Shaking his head, 40 through that
David
one. Kind of conceded he was going to score 45 there, Kevin, didn't he?
Did it on purpose. Saw John Park take out the 164 to win. He wants the 161. Might not get the chance.
100.
He will get the
David
chance.
Car 161.
David Cameron when he comes back. Bit of advice, David. Go big 10 for double 5. If you come back. And he is coming back.
65. David Duclair, 20.
So he has been dodgy on double 10. But he's been delightful on double 5. And he heeds Mark Webster's advice.
David Cameron.
And in doing so, wins the fifth set.
First leg is Kevin to throw first.
Again, in set play. Unlike the best, he's got to find two legs again now, Kev. He was only 100 or so points away. But
140.
Kevin knows. A couple of holes a throw. And he sets up that rematch with Robert Thornton.
Been
impressed with David Cameron. Despite all the woes on doubles, there's been no head shaking. He's just got on with business and
77.
He's worked his way back into the tie. Needs to find a break in this set.
Painter will indeed want to avoid the drama of a deciding set.
Yeah, when you've led 3-1, it's stating the obvious, but the last thing you want is a deciding set, and he'd be against the darts as well.
97.
Pick off. Doesn't even finish, but best he could have hoped for, really. After he should have come down a lot earlier or started down the bottom of the board.
58.
Just muttering away to himself. Kev. He needs to be careful here, Kev.
Yeah, He's starting to stutter a little bit now, Kevin, isn't he? And David Cameron.
Kevin, you recall? Wins to that last start.
Sometimes treble 16, yeah, or two double 18s, and just sort of throws 81. The last dart away. But Cameron,
you've got 85
to hit the front in this sixth set.
It's a bullseye.
60. Kevin, you're
wrong side of the ring. Painter gets the opportunity to nudge his nose in front once more.
Well, will he regret not being a little bit more clinical on the last dart of his previous visit, because he's only having two darts.
16.
And there's the risk.
David, you require
it's
25.
Only one extra dart, but when you come into the board, you're a lot more confident, relaxed, and you've got three in hand.
Now, is that dart in the way? Or can he get over
game
it? He gets over
flag.
It through the flight
David
and
Cameron.
In. He should have just saved
Second
all the business
David
there and gone 15 double five
game
mark.
On.
It's unbelievable how prolific he is on double five. Nothing else on the board. And double five is not a nice double. But it's working for David Cameron.
Well,
it's working for him, working his way into the tie now.
Yeah, Peyton missed two darts to hold his throw there. Now he has to break or he finds himself tied at 3-3 in sets. And
34.
With Cameron throwing first in the decider.
And I stand by that careless start at the big 16 at hitting 8. Cost Kevin
16.
He was one leg away in the previous set. Had a look at 161, didn't get a dart for the match. See
one
Kevin leg. Painter again, maximum number 5, and he's talking away to himself as he's swinging the match back in his favour.
There's been some good scoring in this match, but some troubling doubling at times.
140.
Good response from Kev. Can dwell on things at times, certainly hasn't dwelled on that previous leg. And we'll go one leg away again
60.
For the match if
Kevin,
he tidies up this 47, but on this occasion we'll have the darts.
Game shot on the second leg. Kevin
Excellent
Painter.
Response from Kevin Painter. That is absolutely superb.
Kevin to throw first.
An 11 dart leg to break straight back when his back was against the wall.
Game on.
And now, instead of facing the prospect of throwing second in a deciding set, he's throwing in this leg to win the match.
And he said, "Done, but do that again, Kevin. You're forcing your opponent to produce a 9 darter, but already."
39.
Can't find a treble. Nerves. And can David Cameron jump on that? Just one neat, tidy leg.
134.
Wow, Kevin Painter already chasing, and he's smiling away, but I assure you.
140.
Good visit. Sarcastic nod, but he's still well and truly. In this leg, it was like a sarcastic nod, as if it was too little too late, but really at the early part of the leg.
140.
David Cameron forcing the issue.
Well,
Cameron down to 127 after 9 darts as he bids to cling on to life at Lakeside here at the World Seniors Darts Masters. Kevin Painter trying to make a big move.
121.
That one could cost him, though.
127.
He's on a finish, but David Cameron not going to get a dart. How's your setup? Treble 16, treble 20 is the likely.
57. Kevin Nakar, 143.
We would have had 34.
60. David, you require 70.
Well, David Cameron has missed 27 darts at double in this match. He gets two to stay in the match.
Game shot on the
and we are going the distance
Danny
here
Cameron.
At the Masters. Cameron has clawed his way back
seven
despite
the
all
set,
the missed doubles.
Leg. It's David to throw
it's
first.
A final set.
Game on.
And he has the darts in this decider. Remember, just two legs to win the set. Kevin Painter in peril of an early exit here at the Lakeside.
137.
Kevin Painter has been one away on two occasions, but he'll feel like he's further away than ever now.
140.
But David Cameron has dug in deep because the doubles haven't happened for him, but a rare dart successful at tops sends us to this decider. And two holes a throw. And David Cameron is through to face Robert Thornton.
It can change so quickly, and we're seeing that here. And it could have changed quickly in the first match. People might think I'm silly saying that when John Tart won it 4-0, but Paul Lim was there or thereabouts, wasn't he, for much of the match, in many of the legs,
99.
In many of the sets.
David Yukar, 128.
The tie is slipping away from Kevin Painter. Sixteen for tops, and nothing Kevin can do.
His only hope, really.
88.
Is more Cameron calamity on the doubles. Painter's been more than twice as good in that department. A 45%. Double
65.
Success rate
you require 40.
In comparison to a 20% success rate from this man who hits 20 to leave 20, which he can't hit, but he can hit this.
No score. Kevin Yukar, well, 160.
I'd say that's better than coming in on the five, but he'll feel edgy when he returns. If he returns. Doing Kevin a disservice there. Unlucky with the first start. But just stay focused, because there's no guarantees in this game.
40.
Feel like he threw those last two darts a bit too quickly.
South.
Game shot on the first
and then
leg.
It goes, and
David
it could
Cameron.
Be going wrong here for Kevin Painter.
Seven
Cameron
Kevin just threw first.
Is now Game one on. Leg away from the win. Painter has been there before.
97.
Painter at the point of no return needs these next two legs. Cameron, credit to him, has dug in deep here. Is he going to complete the turnaround?
140.
And dump the semi-finalist from the inaugural World Seniors World Championship out in the first round, in the prelim round,
99.
Here at the Masters.
There's not had an awful lot of success at the Lakeside. In years gone by, David Cameron, he's been here a handful of times.
105.
This is his 15th match on that stage. He's lost 10 of the previous 14. His first appearance was a defeat in a World Masters prelim, funnily enough, back in 1998 to Les Wallace, who we'll see tomorrow against John Lowe.
Yeah, Lowe ball in action tomorrow.
Is it going to be a victory in a World Masters prelim for David
95.
Cameron on this occasion?
Wow, we head in to a deciding leg. Kevin's going to be in pressure on that 105. What a 105 it was from Joe Cullen. Congratulations, Joe, into the playoffs on debut last night.
It's got to be top stops, hasn't it? It's over the top from Kevin Painter.
45.
And his race could be run.
He
was fancied following his exploits at the Circus Tavern. But here at the Lakeside,
game
Painter is put out.
Cameron
clinches it. A comeback win in the deciding set. It goes to David Cameron of Canada, who joins John Part in going through, and we will hear from him with Helen.
Ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation for Kevin Painter this evening. come here. I think the first thing you ought to do is go up and kiss that double five.
Oh my God, it's been amazing. Like I tried my best here and I fell a little bit behind, but I stayed confident, just kept my head down and wanted to win. So
it was an incredible match to watch, swinging this way and that way. What was it like to play in?
As I say, Kevin's been around for a long time. He's a great player, amazing player. You know, it's just it's always good when you play somebody that you feel is really is a good player, and it will push you. So I definitely felt like I was pushed, but I was successful, so pretty happy.
How was it feeling though when you were getting ahead in legs, and the doubles just weren't quite going in?
That's what I'm saying. That's the game. It can be a silly game sometimes. And you just, as I say, you just got to stay with it and just keep pushing, right? So we'll see what happens.
And that's absolutely what you did. Right, you're into the next round. Robert Thornton is waiting for you next.
Yeah, hey, you know what? It's just another player. Great player, of course, but he got to beat me. I don't got to beat him, so we'll see what happens.
This is the thing. We shouldn't be surprised at your performance because you're no stranger to Lakeside.
Yeah, as I say, I've been here enough, and I will break through. It just showed today. Again, you know, a few other times it did. But I definitely feel confident, so we'll see what happens.
And that was a scalp and a half, so well done. David Cameron, ladies and gentlemen, into the next round, facing Robert Thornton. David, thank you very much. Well done. That's our second game tied up tonight. Our third game is on the way. Roland Scholten plays Wayne Jones on this stage for our third game tonight. We'll see you in a couple of minutes after the break.
Welcome back to the Lakeside Country Club. Bobby George is watching the actions as seniors, World Darts Masters make some progress. Tell you what, Kevin Painter, keep out of his way, I reckon. He will be mad. Well done, David Cameron. He was out of that, and he came right back and won it.
Well, Kev had his chances. He threw a loose start here and eight. Now you've got to have two darts out of double, and he mucked it right up.
Impressed with David Cameron?
Yeah, but to beat David.
Yeah.
But every camera I've got, he played well. He come back, he had loads and loads of darts at doubles. Double five. It's one of the worst doubles. You could double three and double five. Horrible doubles on the top. But he'd have double five and he was getting it in the end.
Bobby, I told you, double five makes number 10 for David Cameron.
Oh, yeah.
So he goes through and it's a good performance. Now, next up, we've got Roland Scholten against Wayne Jones. I've heard people whispering around the building today that Wayne Jones is quite a contender.
Wayne Jones, tough player. Always goes for the throat, as I say. Never gives up. So I think he'll beat Roland.
You think he'll beat Roland, yeah?
Me, he will, yeah. He's that sort of guy.
Why'd you say that, Bob?
Because he's been playing in different tournaments, and apparently he's played very well. So, and he's actually qualified for this. So it's anyone who qualifies gets through, they've got to be a tidy player.
Bob, sometimes can you arrive at a tournament and think, my practice has been good and you feel in really good shape, and especially at a venue like this, and sometimes you can walk out there and it just doesn't happen for you. Is there no rhyme or reason to it? Or sometimes it's that good practice and the majority of times it carries you through?
Well, practice is to play competitions. You know, you can play on your dartboard at home and everything, practice, but it's practicing against a good player. And when you get up here, if you don't hit the doubles, you've had it. It's cutthroat. You know, you miss a double, you lose a set, easy.
Well, in this format as well, as the guys in the box are saying for the last game, it's changing like that. Just before the next game gets going, I just want to ask you once again about the Lakeside stage. Because, yes, we're talking about great champions from down the years, all the great champions have played here down the years, because this was before darts changed, before the BBC came in, the Lakeside and the BDO, that was it. But in a way, what did it mean for those hundreds, I would say, down the years, of players who maybe were never going to win the title, but qualified to play here? You used to tell me that getting through the qualifiers, it was like you'd won a championship to get to walk out here.
Oh yeah, the toughest, all the games in the playoff are tough. You know, you get 128 guys playing down to two or three or four people, say. They cut it down a bit further in there, but that's tough. You have to really be on form. So guys who qualify deserve their spot. And you can never say, oh, I was a qualifier. You know, unless they're qualified themselves, they wouldn't say it.
I wandered outside this afternoon by the side of the lake, and it reminded me that down the years, if you had a little bit of a dredge of that lake, there must be hundreds of darts, because the number of times we've seen players have a nightmare, walk out the back, fling their darts into the lake.
I remember Gary Anderson. It was solid ice, and he lost. He threw his darts, and he stuck in the ice. He thought, I don't know, shall I go and get them back? Better not. And over the couple of days, they sink it. Yeah, so they're still in there. Obviously, they won't want their tungsten. So if you want to go and find them, they've got a few quid.
I hope Chris Mason won't mind me saying this.
He's done it at all.
Chris had a nightmare one day, and then he went out there and threw his darts. And then you came back and said, Mason's just thrown his darts at the lake. He nearly missed. Because he was having quite a bad time. But I'm laughing, but I'm not being nasty about it, because it just showed me how much it means.
Well,
how much it means to come here, then it doesn't go right for you. It was so important.
Well, you have to dream about it. You have to practice and dream you've won. You dream you're going to win. I've won it. And when it comes and you don't win it, it's a bit of a, you know, letdown, like. And you get upset. I never used to throw me darts in there.
No.
Only with flights. Used to throw me flights in the boat.
Do you have great, great memories of this place as a venue, because you had great times here. The guys were talking about before, but when you played in the World Championship final and sort of got had a bad defeat, but you had a broken back, by the way. I think everyone should remember you had a broken back virtually.
Yeah,
you had to play in something metal corset, didn't you?
Yeah, terrible. It was terrible. No suspender belt, just a corset I had. No, it was bad. That was it. So the thing is, I still played the final, which I shouldn't have played it, really. But I thought, I've got through the semi, I'll have a go. And they say, the comments say, you got done 6-0. I thought, well, they get up there, I played pretty good. I just couldn't move my body to the double. But I scored good, but that's where it was. So I was unfortunate, and there you go. I'm still here, though.
Right. Full of memories, full of great memories, just being in the building. Right, next day, Roland Shelton against Wayne Jones is coming up any minute, but let's just have a short break. Welcome back to the Lakeside Country Club. The Jennings Met World Seniors Darts Masters is underway and making progress here at a venue that has been host of so many great tournaments down the years. It's been a good night for Canada so far tonight. John Part is through, and he's back later to play Phil Taylor, no less. And David Cameron, his countryman, has just beaten Kevin Painter, and he's through to the next round as well. We're just waiting for Roland Shelton and Wayne Jones to come out to play. I know you said that Wayne Jones is the most likely to win this game. Roland Shelton's had a terrific career, hasn't he? And what I'm tempted to say so far, Bob, is in this format, it can all change so quickly.
Oh, yeah. Roland's won a lot of tournaments, obviously. But we haven't seen him for a long time. I've seen him at the Seniors Worlds.
That's right, yeah.
That's the only time I've seen him for quite a few years. So I don't know what he's been planning on, if he's been in tournaments or what. I haven't heard nothing about him. So I can only judge on what I can hear people say. Like Wayne's playing really good, and he's hitting the doubles, and he's, you know, but he just plays right on his, like, he's so excited and manned up. He was sitting on Roland's like a hawk, but the other guy gets pretty manned up. If he misses, he must have beat himself up. But he's quite good to watch. He's good to watch.
Looking forward to this one. Paul Starr is about to introduce the players.
Welcome back to the party, ladies and gentlemen. We are live at the Lakeside. It's a stage where legends played in Darton history was made. Mr. Jennings, Bet World Seniors Darts Masters, and we are ready. The players are ready, and it's tungsten time. And now from Wolverhampton, England, he's a former World Masters finalist, a Genebet World Darts Masters qualifier. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Wanderer, Wayne Jones!
now from The Hague in the Netherlands. He's a former World Grand Prix finalist, a Premier League finalist, ladies and gentlemen. Please welcome the 2014 UK Open champion. He is the tripod, Roland Shotton!
Welcome back. The action continues here at the Lakeside at this first ever World Seniors Darts Masters. And it's been a cool night for Canada so far. John Park producing a magical moment on the legendary Lakeside stage. A 1-6-4 checkout in his 4-0 win against Paul Lim. And then David Cameron joining Park in reaching the last 16, getting the better of Kevin Painter in a game that swung one way then the other. But Cameron got the job done, and attention now turns to this meeting between the Wanderer Wayne Jones, who managed to work his way through the qualifier to get here, 57 years of age, from Wolverhampton, and he takes on the Dutchman Roland Shotton, also 57, from The Hague in the Netherlands, winner of the UK Open back in 2004 when he beat John Park in the final. Plenty of Lakeside legends on the stage, and one joins me in the commentary box as well. Yes, Mark Webster has had a bit of a break, and I'm delighted to say that Dennis Priestley is alongside me.
Delighted to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
Delighted with what you've seen so far. I mean, that John Park magical moment was the standout party piece, as you put it to me,
yeah,
off air.
Yeah, well, a lovely 1-6-4.
First set, first
we've
leg.
We've got two Canadians through already.
To first. Game on.
Well, we've got to wait to see what happens in the last game.
Yeah, Park v Taylor.
Yeah.
That will tantalise the taste buds. But this pair, two players, well, there's not many darts players that you don't know
85.
A lot about, Dennis, but you certainly spent time playing with and then watching these two.
Yes, I have. I've known them. I've known Wayne probably 35 years.
55.
Yeah, always a good competitor. And Roland. Roland's actually stayed with us when there's been a tournament at Barnsley Metrodome. Yeah, it's good. They're both good
100.
Lads.
Shotton accepting his invite. As I said, Wayne Jones came through one of the qualifying events. He
100.
Beat Robert Rickwood in the final after getting another win over Richie Houghton, who is in this tournament because he's top of the order of merit, and also a man who's pretty local to you as well, Dennis. Darren Johnson he beat in the semis.
Yeah, man, we live on the same street, actually. Darren, always been a good player, just not had that luck to break through. Funnily enough, we were speaking the other day and I said,
one out of
you're definitely the best player on Church Street now, Darren.
I think it'll take some going for anybody to beat your record in that part of the world. Of course, a winner of the World Masters in 1992. A win here at the Lakeside as well in 91. That was really when you were at the peak of your powers, wasn't it?
138.
Well, yeah, I came to the forefront in, obviously, 91 when I won the Embassy. Threw me, you know, into the limelight in the darting world.
100, Roland Yukwa, 68.
And then went on and played fairly decent and had a tremendous 92, actually.
32.
36.
For Shotton.
Wayne Yukwa, 96.
Couldn't manage it, so 96 for Wayne Jones to hold on to his throw in the opening leg.
Double eight, is it?
80.
On the wire.
Roland Yukwa, 32.
So two 16s for the Dutchman.
He's
left him in.
When you require 16.
I don't think Wayne will miss this.
Game shot on the first leg.
It's like you know what you're talking about, Dennis.
Second leg rolling to throw first.
I've had my moments.
Game on.
Yeah, certainly had more than a few moments. That Masters win, by the way, I must mention, you beat Mike Gregory in the final. It's all about celebrating the
100.
The trailblazers in this sport, and we've sadly lost Mike since the World Seniors Championship before the start of this tournament, but what a player he was.
He was a great competitor. As I was speaking earlier,
100.
I won the World Masters in 92 and I was two sets to nail down. And they talk about 100 averages, and I had
140.
I had 34 point something per dart.
Yeah, stunning stuff. Both players in that match averaged more than 100 over five
41.
Sets.
41.
Wayne Johnson, 60. Having won the first leg, can wrap up the first set if he can win this one. This short, sharp format, the format that you played when you won the World Masters, Dennis, it really is. There's a lot of 60. Jeopardy involved, isn't there? We saw in the last match how quickly it can change.
Yeah, like I said, I was two sets down and managed to fight back and win 3-2. And there was only one game that went above 15 darts. And that was the final leg when we both had jelly legs. And I managed to check out in 17 darts. Yeah, I remember it vividly.
100, rolling your car, 112.
You do, you always remember the wins better than the losses.
Let's see if Roland Charlton can manage to check out this 112, because if he doesn't, he could drop the first set in double quick time. Jones 38. Will return,
when
trying to take out a
100.
Ton.
Every chance now.
Game shot on the first set. Wayne Jones. Sing set first leg, rolling to throw first. Game on.
Yeah, lovely stuff. That must make you feel good, Dennis, when you see 100 checkout go out in two darts. Treble, double, no problem at all.
Yeah, Paul Lim did
100.
It earlier. Yeah, it's a lovely way.
100.
It's nice to see so many people
60.
Coming and supporting it. I was a little surprised when I entered it. I mean, I've not been back since January 93, and
45.
It seemed a lot bigger place then. Obviously, it's not, but it just seemed bigger.
Did you still get the old goosebumps
100.
Wandering in?
Yeah, I did. Yeah, nostalgia was there. I was looking forward to coming and doing this.
140.
It's the first chance we've had to speak to you since the World Seniors Championship. You presented the trophy, of course, to Robert Thornton, but it really did seem to capture the imagination, didn't it? The crowd were well up for it, the viewing figures were good.
Yeah, it was well, obviously it was the first one, and you don't know what's going to happen, how it's going to pan out, but speaking with Jason after, that everybody were quite
41.
Happy.
41. When you call 167.
174 to set up the 167. We've already seen the 164 from John Part. Jones not going to add this one to the roll of honour.
95.
There's a lot go a different way now for 164. They go two triple 19s, which is probably
96.
Makes sense. You know, you're not,
when you require,
you're not switching all over the board.
Yeah, we see all sorts of different finishes, but at the World Seniors Championship, or the World Seniors Masters as this one is. What does he think? Does he think he's hit the treble 16?
33.
He thought he'd hit the treble 16 there, and he hadn't. He hit the treble 7.
That's what happens when you get a little bit older. Your eyes aren't as good.
Well, double topped.
Game shown on the first leg.
Yeah.
Roland Shogun. Sound like Wayne did on first. Song. Game on.
Yeah, I was going to say, at these World Seniors events, you expect... It is the old school, isn't it? So you expect the old school roots.
Yeah, you certainly do.
125.
I also remember when we played the Embassy and I took a 146 out and I went 2 treble 19s.
45.
Double 16. And he didn't shout game. And I thought, have I gone wrong here or what? Anyway, realised that it was game shot. Because nobody had gone that way before. Yeah.
Dennis Priestley, tungsten trailblazer. But you see a lot of players now going sort of double routes.
96.
Yeah.
Utilising the bullseye at the start of checkouts rather than the end of checkouts.
Exactly, yeah.
The game always evolving, and this World Seniors 60. Tour is an example of that.
Yeah, long may it continue.
Wayne Jones, you know, I mentioned that he got through the qualifiers to get to this event, and it's no surprise, really. He was a master of coming through qualifiers during his career on the main tour. Jones managed to make it through the qualifiers for the World Championship, World Grand Prix, Grand Slam, and World Series of Darts.
Oh, what a record. He's always been a steely competitor. Trouble if there is a fault with Wayne's game, he's too hard on himself. I mean, we'd all like to have thrown, you know, perfect games, perfect, you know, thrown perfect darts, but it's never going to happen.
Excellent player, Wayne Jones, but never won a ranking title. Despite multiple finals, including, in fact, the World Masters
60.
In 1999. There's Richie Howson, who we will see in action tomorrow.
Yes, he acquitted himself brilliantly in February at Circus Tavern.
What a mess this is from Wayne Jones. Well,
no score.
He said he's too hard on himself. I think he deserves to be hard on himself there. He tried to split. He missed the board entirely and then hit a 15 going for the two. You think he might just go straight for the double nine when he comes back?
I think he will, yeah.
When you require 18.
Yes, he is.
Well, now he has to split. And it's double four.
14.
All right.
Roland, you require 76.
Can Roland do the 76?
Game
well, it's double eight, and
set.
He gets the second Roland set on it. Shulton. And Roland Shulton has levelled up after a real mess, a real wobble from Wayne Jones at the end of that set. He wanders off the stage, wondering how he's still not playing in the set, but it is one apiece at the break. Well, on we go then here at the World Seniors Masters, where Wayne Jones will be wondering how this match is level at one apiece. He really made a mess of his finishing in the last leg before the break, which Roland Shulton stole to win the second set 2-0 after Wayne Jones
first leg, it's Wayne to throw first.
Won the first
game on
by the same scoreline. And Dennis, you made the point before the break that he's a player who can be hard on himself, so yeah, important for him now to put that behind him.
Yeah, he's got to refocus. Yeah,
100.
I like that little quip though, what you got in there. Wonder how he lost that set.
Yeah, the Wolverhampton Wanderer, that's why he's got that nickname. A big fan.
Oh, 100.
Massive fan of Wolves,
and they were a massive fan of him when he appeared at the Grand Slam of Darts.
Yeah, he got tremendous support there, didn't he?
100.
I suppose you're used to tremendous support wherever you go, Dennis.
Yeah, I've had my moments. Sheffield actually comes into mind when I played Premier League. I think I played Colin Lloyd, and the support was absolutely tremendous for me, and I think it unnerved Colin.
140.
I think I won 7-0 or something.
But if you're watching, Colin.
Yeah, nice one, Colin. I hope you're keeping well.
85, when you require 161.
The 161, it's been a decent response.
That's
after
the
that.
One anyway.
Yeah, it's got it on. There's a 60. Yeah.
76.
Well, he'll have taken that, but he still won't feel comfortable, will he, spraying the darts around?
No. Roland's well back, so...
81.
He's got that,
when you require 85.
He's taken two off it, so 83 remaining. Treble 17. Another wayward one. Well, I'll tell you what, his darts... are the wanderers, aren't they?
Yeah.
20.
Yes, certainly are.
Now, Roland Charlton, he lost in the prelim at the World Seniors Championship to Terry Jenkins, a player who maybe surprised a few there. People thought
85.
He hadn't been playing, but he had been behind
when
the scenes and
65.
Made the semi-finals.
This is how I was
Game show
to
the
ask.
First leg. Wayne
at,
Jones.
At one stage, you know.
Second leg rolling.
Is that
the throw first.
In? Is it
game on?
Well, you know. And then I went and had laser surgery 21 years ago now. And it started
85.
Reversing after about eight or 9 years.
Yeah, well, it certainly helps being able to see what you're going for, doesn't it?
Oh, yeah.
And we saw that problem with Wayne Jones earlier on when he thought he did a treble 16. It was actually a treble 7, and he
100.
Wasted two darts going for a double that he hadn't left.
That's right. Yeah, crucial part of our game. I mean, obviously your arm's got 16. To be good, but your eyesight, if it's 20-20, that's brilliant.
And as for Roland Charlton, top player over the
45.
Years mentioned at the top of the match, he won the UK Open in 2004. He also won an event called the PDC World Pairs with Raymond van Barneveld in 97.
60.
Was that I think that was the year after me and Eric won it.
It would have been, yeah.
We won it in Ayr, and then I think we moved down to
60.
Salford Rugby Club.
Well, there he is. Terry Jenkins, the man we just mentioned.
The ball.
Beat this man 3-0 at the Circus Tavern in February.
100.
He's best at the Lakeside, Roland Charlton. A run to the semi-finals in 98, losing to Richie Burnett. You know, Mark Webster will feel bad because I did
85.
Do research just for a bit of fun on his head-to-head against all the players, and I didn't realise he wasn't commentating with me in this match, and it's actually the only player of all of them we'll see tonight that Webster had a better record against.
41.
I won't bother doing it for you, Dennis. I know that you've got a better record against all of them.
He's a world champion, though, Mark, so you can't
60.
Take that away
Roll
from
your
him.
Car 155.
Yeah, but we just won't remind him of it too much.
No.
Well, this is on treble 19 for double 19.
Oh. 117.
Oh, lucky Roland.
When you were car 151.
Well, this would be for the set. Won't happen, though, so Charlton will come back for double 19, should he choose to go straight for it.
60. Roland, you were car 38.
Yeah, he could go single 6.
Game shot of the second leg.
I mean, they always
Roland
say
Charlton.
They always say the doubles are the same size.
Third leg wins you through first. Game on.
But you've always got the preference which way which double you'd like to leave yourself.
Yeah, some are in more difficult places, aren't they?
Yeah. You never see them finishing on double 17. If anybody wants a bet out there, see what odds they'll give you. For the game to be won on double 17.
100!
Very rarely seen. Well, 180 is not yet seen in this match. We did have a fair few in the match between Kevin Painter,
83.
David Cameron.
What's the running total so far on the 180s? Did you keep a check?
I can't, 83. I won't be able to find out, Dennis. I'll just check my information device. Just keep talking for what, 7 minutes?
And Wayne's it just hit the big one. I think that's in treble 20.
121.
Good follow up after hitting single one. That's a sign of a quality player. Roland's in.
140.
Yeah, good follow. Yeah, they're quite evenly matched.
Well, you won't be going for the 180 here.
137.
Leave 60. It's just a matter if Roland can put the pressure on.
100. When you require 60.
It's a good guider for tops.
Game shot on the third set. Wayne Jones. Fourth set first leg is Roland to throw first. Game on.
So there is a third set for Wayne Jones. Two away from a place in the last 16. To answer your question, Dennis, they've got us on 8 maximum so far. None of them in this match.
No.
26.
The bulk of them was in the last match. Yeah.
Yeah, the high scoring in that match, but there were some problems on the doubles, particularly for the man who actually ended up winning the game, yeah. David Cameron.
I had on the table, there's three bets by Jennings, and I think I put 11 180s for the year, for the session.
Well, Phil Taylor still to come, don't forget. And he'll take on John Part.
Well, Phil's obviously going to be hoping he plays a lot 55. Better than Circus Tavern in February.
Do you expect him to?
I do expect him to, to be. He couldn't be any worse, I don't think. Not on this standard of play.
30.
Like, as you see, Wayne's giving himself hard times.
They're having a good time, but he's having a hard time at the moment. Despite being in front in the match, has won the only set which went
140.
2-3 legs to get the narrow advantage. The winner of this match will take on Martin Adams tomorrow. That's a tough test 58. For whoever gets through, the man who made the final at the Circus Tavern.
Paul Lynch has been impeccable again, no mistakes. Very good counter, good mathematician. Yeah, he actually lives in my town, actually. I introduced him to his wife.
You could have a right little darts tournament in your town, 60. Couldn't you?
He's a better caller than a player. He'll not get to hear that anyway. No doubt he'll have everything taping back home.
45.
Yeah, one of the unsung heroes of this sport. But it's more than just calling out the numbers, isn't it?
30.
Certainly is. Roland giving himself a hard time.
Yeah, the pair are just
in a slump just at present.
Yeah, that's.
It just needs something 45. To add.
Roland, you were a
good big finish or another big score, and they'll be back on track.
You can't get the big finish, but a decent enough score to get him back on track.
Now Wayne needs to put the pressure on. Could be a travel here.
90. Roland Newquar, 54.
But in contrast to the previous match, the scoring hasn't been great, but the doubling has been decent so far in this one. And Shulton carries that on. He's 4 out of 10 now.
Nice goal.
Second leg is Wayne to throw first. Game on.
and 4 out of 9 for Wayne Jones.
The averages aren't fantastic, but that relates to how many darts has been missed at double.
Well, we were looking 16. At this, me and Mark Webster, and kind of just from what we've got to go on the World Seniors Championship as to what a standard game is in the World Seniors, and we think sort of mid-80s average is okay. Anything above 90 is pretty good.
Very good, yes. Yeah. I mean, obviously, all the viewers have got to realise they're not as good as what they used to be.
81.
This pair were battling it out some
78.
10 years ago, the last meeting. It's actually 15 years since Shulton got a win over Wayne Jones.
Is that right?
Yeah, the head-to-head reads 8-2 in Wayne's favour.
93. Wow.
Surprising.
And Shulton certainly had more success, didn't he? As I mentioned, Jones, many people would say he's one of the best players never to have won a ranking title in either code.
60.
He did win a Challenge Tour event as he dropped down to that sort of secondary tour and finally tasted 100. Tournament victory, but maybe, you know, there's success ahead of him in the seniors.
Yeah, let's hope so. Revive his career.
94. Rolling you a car, 167.
It's been a lovely day down here, and it's not 78. It's not looking as if it's too hot up on stage.
110.
We've played it many a time when it's been 100 degrees on stage. It's been horrendous.
Well, I just want to leave this handy because 89 means that Shulton may only get a look at the bullseye.
Yeah. Oh, Roland.
Doesn't even get that.
28. When you acquire 56.
You're in between when you want 70, whether to go at treble 20 and or go for the fat 20 and it
38.
You know, go for the ball.
Roland, you acquire 61.
It looks like he was in two minds.
Well, a missed opportunity there for Jones. And it's 16 double 16. 13 off that leaves 48. This to level the match in sets.
Tops.
Ooh, 26.
Drag that one down.
When you require 18.
Bit of a snatch.
Won't be splitting it. Game, he'll be hitting it instead. He levels up.
Wayne Jones.
The fourth set at one apiece.
Third leg is rolling to throw first. Game on.
Looking at the averages, there's not a lot in them actually.
Yeah, it's been a slog in the scoring stakes, and I mean, it was a real 100. Dodgy dart double there from Roland Shulton, but Wayne Jones in particular has been in good fettle on the outer ring. 5 out of 11.
Yeah, a lot of professionals in
60.
In the younger game would be pleased with that. Potentially, there's a lot of
41.
Over 50s playing on the main tour. What are eligible to drop down into this within the next couple of years, maybe?
Yeah, well, it will take some drop for some of them because the world number one at the moment and world champion is over 50, isn't he, Peter Wright?
That's right. That's right.
We'll see what you did there. But yeah, the likes of,
60.
Say, Steve Beaton, for example.
Steve Beaton, Gary Anderson. Just to mention two.
Yeah, that's another good thing about the seniors. There are always going to be a
44.
A conveyor belt of legends ready to join this tour. But I have to say, I do think, and I put Wayne Jones in this category and Richie Howson, who we saw earlier, I do think we
43.
Will see events where the qualifiers are perhaps big dangers, because it qualifying for this event shows that you're playing well.
Yeah, yeah, and you're still keen on playing darts.
100.
Are you still keen on playing darts, Dennis, or are yours locked away?
I was just going to come in on that fact.
100.
I was obviously asked to participate, and I declined, obviously, because, you know, not keen enough to want to practice.
140, rolling your car, 157.
I'll get competitive again.
Yeah, that's fair enough.
A lot of old dart players kid themselves.
81, when you require 97.
They can still do it, but you know, you've got to be realistic.
Well, the doubling has been decent. Double 10 for a 97 out. And that's a big moment for Wayne Jones.
Wayne Jones,
because he takes the fourth set and now needs just one more to book his place in the last 16 and a meeting with Wolfie Martin Adams.
Yeah, Roland's average has just dropped slightly.
140.
Now he's got a bit between the teeth now. You might see a 4-1 win here now.
Is Roland rolling over?
He gets the darts in, 60. In this leg and the third leg as well. So you would expect a win now for Wayne Jones. Got to let a little bit of steam off, because he's red-faced, isn't he?
Yeah, and he might have to up it against Adams if we see the Adams that we did see at the Circus Tavern.
60.
He was in fine form, but then again, he has since appeared at the WDF World Championship here at the Lakeside. He was beaten in the first round.
138.
It was young Jared Cole.
Oh, right. Oh, I remember watching the game. Yeah, he was a shadow of himself, wasn't he?
100.
Didn't produce
when you fire 128.
Anything like his game.
Well, he could go treble 20 bolt. Well, Shulton a long way back. And
92.
Just start to get the sense that Shulton himself might be feeling like a beaten man.
44. When you acquire 36.
Yes, if he keeps that up, I'm afraid he'll be on the first.
Game shot on the
first leg. Ferry on
Wayne Jones.
Morning.
Second leg rolling to through first. Game on.
Yeah, Wayne Jones really does look like he means business at the moment.
Struck his average into the 80s.
140.
Let's hope Roland proves us wrong and wins us a set, take us into another
99.
Set. They're enjoying themselves.
Yeah, well, Shulton will have to hold here and then break. Wayne Jones is throwing the following leg.
66.
Oh, what a good last start.
And that's made all the more difficult when Wayne Jones has now hit 50% of the doubles that he's gone for in this match.
Yeah.
101.
Like you said earlier, even the guys on the top pro tour would be very, very pleased with that 50%.
100.
A reminder of what's happened so far this evening. John Part winning the opening match 4-0 against Paul Lim.
58.
David Cameron then got the better of Kevin Painter in a seventh and deciding set. And Park went through to take on Phil Taylor. That match is coming up next. A repeat of a couple of 90. World finals.
I was talking with John earlier. He's up for it. He's very pleased with the way he played. And obviously, he came off stage
60.
With that big
Rowan
finish, which,
car 105.
Which might keep the momentum going against Phil. I don't think it'll be one-sided. That is a certainty.
Game
oh, brilliant finish from Roland Shulton.
Roland Shulton.
Was hoping to make this match look less one-sided. 105 checkout. Both of them now have had a three-figure finish 100. In this match. But in this snappy format, first of two legs to win a set, so many important legs.
60.
Yes, but it's only three legs. Yeah, it's very difficult. The Wimowell Masters used to be three legs like this. Obviously,
100.
When they played in the Embassy, it was five legs to a set. You get that little bit more time to settle. If you don't get the first leg in the first set,
100.
It's crucial, with it only being three legs.
This tournament modelled on the Masters, which actually was played here a few times, has been played in various different venues.
It was at the Holiday Inn, Earl's Court, where I won it. Big room. The Rotherham United players were staying at the hotel.
130.
They came and watched the morning rounds. And I actually won it, and they were playing at Craven Cottage, playing Fulham. And I got there for half time with the trophy.
When you require 111.
At least they had one win to cheer on that day. Here's Wayne Jones about to win here. Treble 17. Would have given him a dart at top. Shulton then can save his skin with 95.
Got a new bar, 95.
I think he'll go at the bull here. No, straight at it. Go on, Roland.
57.
That could be it.
When you require 68.
He gets a call of go on from Dennis Priestley, but it doesn't go in, and he might go out. Because Jones wants 16 and double 16.
36.
And a missed dart for the match.
When you require 38.
Will he go straight for this? He elected to leave it, so. Ah. Big dart.
30.
That
when you require 32.
There's a handful squandered to stay in it, and now Wayne Jones, who's been so good on the doubles, carries on that efficient checking out, and it sees Roland Scholten, the Dutchman, dumped out of the World Series Masters at the first hurdle. Jones goes through to take on Martin Adams, and we're going to hear from the Wanderer now. He's talking to Helen.
Ladies and gentlemen, your appreciation for Roland Scholten. Roland, we'll see you again next time. Don't keep me waiting. What? You've won?
Yeah, terrific. That was shit.
Oh, no! Oh, no, 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 we can't. Right, I'm not going to say it this time. I'm not going to say it.
Don't swear.
I'm not going to do the cuss words. Wayne! Welcome back.
Yeah, thanks.
It's lovely to see you again.
I've got nothing to say with that. That was terrible. So, I felt really good coming up and played absolutely crap. Luckily, Roland let me win.
Stop swearing.
That's not swearing.
Well, all right, we're after the watershed, but stop.
That was terrible. Terrible.
What is it like playing in a game? I mean, I know I can see your demeanour. You've just won, but you're not allowing yourself to celebrate at all. There's no...
What can I celebrate about that?
And is it... What's it like during a game when your opponent has a poor visit to the board and then so do you? What do you do to yourself in your head?
I didn't do anything. I just kept hoping he'd score less than I did and couldn't finish. And luckily, he did both. So that was rubbish.
Well, look, come on, you were 50% on your doubles.
Did I? Probably on your score as well, wasn't it?
Wayne, come on!
No, that was terrible. I've got no excuse for that. That was just...
Right, OK, so what I will say then is you can't do that again next round because you've got Martin Adams.
If I play like that, I'm not going to win, am I, so...
Right, attitude, come on, get your head right. What are you going to do? Are you going to... When will you be able to let that go? Will you go back tonight and think about it, or is that gone now? Let's move on.
Oh yeah, I'm not sleeping tonight after that. That was rubbish.
Did you beat yourself up?
Big time.
Oh, no.
That was so bad. I thought I was throwing well, practiced well, got up there, and that was just... I think the best thing to do is when they close tonight, I'm going to come in and have a couple of hours while nobody's here.
I think I better let him go, and I'm just going to start to cry for you.
Are you going to come with me?
No, you've won! Wayne, you've won! Wayne Jones, Wayne, it is lovely to see you back, and we will see you in the next round. Congratulations. Off he goes. I've never interviewed anybody so after he's won a match. Oh, ladies and gentlemen, you know what's coming up next. Our fourth game live on this stage. After the break, we have Phil Taylor, John Part, live.
Welcome back to the Lakeside Country Club, and here we go then. John Pard is about to play Phil Taylor. Phil Taylor tempted out of retirement to play on the Seniors Tour. When he played in the World Championship at Purfleet, he really didn't like it. He didn't play well, and he went out early in the competition. And he left saying he'd be much better prepared this time round. He really struggled to turn the power back on. What are you expecting now?
The thing about Phil Taylor is his finishing power. That's what made him so good. If he missed, he went out. Obviously, I hope he played better than he did. Perfectly, obviously. I want to see him play like he can do. But Hart played pretty well.
Yes.
I mean, you know, and won 6-4 out to win the match. So over this short format, it can be dangerous for him. It'd be dangerous.
When Phil Taylor left the World Championship, the Seniors World Championship, he said he was not going to put himself through that again. So, what has happened since? Let's see if the power is going to light up the Lakeside. Over to Paul Starr.
Welcome to the party, ladies and gentlemen. We are live at the Lakeside. Stage where legends played in Jonathan history was made. It's the Jennings Bet World Seniors Darts Masters, and we are ready. The players are ready, and it's tungsten time! And now from Oshawa in Canada, he's a 3 times former champion of the world. He is Darth Maple. He is John Parr. Now from Stoke-on-Trent, England, a Darton legend who's won over 80 TV major titles. He's a record-breaking 16 times champion of the world and is widely regarded as the greatest dart player of all time. It's Phil the Power!
legend returns to the Lakeside as the 16-time champion of the world, Phil the Power Taylor, takes to the hockey to face John Parr in what really is a war between two stars of the sport. Parr booking this meeting with Taylor by seeing off Paul Lim earlier this evening, a 4-0 victory for the great Canadian, who won one of his three world titles by beating Phil Taylor in a famous final at the Circus Tavern. And it was at the Circus Tavern where, well, the power wasn't really powered up, losing out to Kevin Painter in the first World Seniors Championship in the quarterfinals. And he said he will not play like that again. He said we'll see a different Phil Taylor come Lakeside. Well, now the talking is over and it is time for Taylor to step up. John will play his part, of course. He always does. He's having a little bit of a chuckle with our match official there, Paul Hinks. But it is a couple of...
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. First set, first leg. It's John to throw first. Game on.
To end the evening's action. And one of them has departed the commentary box. We're now stuck with Mark Webster.
Yeah, John Parr having a good catch-up with Paul Hinks. He hasn't seen him lately. 55. But John Parr was impressive. Without being spectacular in that opening match, dealt with Paul Lim. Hit the key shots, and as the longer the game went on, the more comfortable he
84.
Looked. But Phil Taylor, who said that he'd be practicing hard because he was nowhere near at his best, even defeating Peter Manley in February at the Circus Tavern, he promised 16. To be better. He's been putting the hours in, he's been on the exhibition circuit a lot as well. Can he dispatch of John Parr here?
Yeah, it could have gone one of two ways, Mark. And many people thought that Phil Taylor, in not being really competitive at the Circus Tavern, might just think, you know what, it's not for me, the World Seniors. That's exactly what Dennis Priestley said in comms in the previous match. He didn't think he could be competitive, so he thought, give someone else a chance. But Taylor's gone the other
38.
Way. Licked his wounds. He wants to come back. He wants to win.
I played in an exhibition with him last week, and it was round robin. He beat Max Hopp, just narrowly lost to Menzel Sulic, but went through the group, lost Dirk,
97.
But came off and he enjoyed, he was happy with how he played. He was around about a 92 average, is what he's a bit above there, but he seems satisfied with how he's playing and how his preparation's going.
93.
But credit to him, he never papered over any cracks. He admitted he was nervous in the last event. I'll hope to be more comfortable here.
Were you happy with how you played at that exhibition?
I did all right, but not about me, is it?
Well, Mark Webster went viral. There's Tony O'Shea, a silverback himself. Yeah, brilliant 170 finish from Mark Webster. Do check that out on whatever social media you use.
100.
Right, I did it for you, Mark.
Thank you, Christopher. Well, Phil Taylor, we've always said, not one of the great counters, leaves 162, but always relied on heavy scoring. Expect him to stack one on top there.
60. John,
yeah,
Parr,
58 to leave that 162, did Taylor. 115 for John Parr. Well, that's a happy accident, isn't it? That's not. That's an unhappy accident.
75.
Oh, Phil Taylor be successful, despite not being able to count. Well, the favourite for the Premier League. Not the best counted either, but Johnny Clayton, table tops, goes into the playoffs. And Taylor of a similar mould in terms of counting. Johnny's got a long way to match the CV of Phil, but a nervy start again here.
78.
I think he Johnny wants to fire up the blocks here, Chris, doesn't he? Really set a precedent from the word go, but...
Oh, it's a wild one from John Parr that denies him a third dart.
24.
At double. And Taylor can break immediately here on double 12.
That looks awkward. He's going to struggle to get in there. Brilliant dart. Really good dart from Phil Taylor. It looked like they covered the bed.
Second leg is filled.
Taylor takes the opening leg. And yeah, not happy with how he's played, but breaks John Parr. So careless from John. But it's Phil Taylor who strikes first in the final match of that opening session here at Lakeside.
The three tournaments, three TV tournaments on the World Seniors Tour in 2022. Its inaugural year. The World Championship, which 59. We've had, of course, a World Match Play coming up later on this year in July.
and the World Masters. Taylor, of course, a 16-time world champion, 16-time world match play winner. But only once did he win the World Masters. That in five attempts. He beat Jockey Wilson to win it in 1990. And then the following year, he lost in the final to a certain Rod Harrington.
140.
And then he kind of kicked into gear, didn't he? Beat Mike Gregory the following year, the late great Mike Gregory. And then as soon as he dominated in the PDC, and even when you say it now, Chris, 16 times.
134.
Ridiculous achievement.
Yeah, that win against Gregory was one of his two wins here at Lakeside in the World Championship. 1990 against Bristow, 92 against Gregory.
99.
And last competitive match on the Lakeside stage, the loss to Kevin Spoilek in 1993 before the split. John Part was the first winner after the split.
22.
Demolishing Bobby George 6-0. Bobby got a bit touchy, didn't he, earlier? He did have a broken back, we need to tell you that. Credit to Bobby.
140.
Well, he's made a strong start here, Phil Taylor. Not in terms of performance level, not in that first leg anyway, but he's on 63 after a dozen darts in the second, and he could be about to wrap up the sets.
Yeah, double 16 for clean sweep of set one.
47.
Will return. Phil Taylor, clearly not happy with how he's playing, but there's going to be nerves. And if you can still win the opening set whilst nervous, and it will surely settle Phil down. John Parr will be kicking himself the manner in which he lost the opening leg, but has offered very little in this leg.
Game shown the first set.
That is the first
Phil
set.
Phil Taylor!
To Phil Taylor, the first
second
set lost
first leg. It's Phil
by John
Parr
this evening. Always a difficult task, Mark, playing twice in a night.
Yeah, only really experienced it in Euro Tours, and not very many of them, to be honest. And in the UK Open, but yeah, I've never experienced it in the
84.
The same session in this sort of format. But
yeah, it happens to one player, doesn't it, at the PDC World Championship now on the very first night, because of round one and round
yeah,
two.
Yeah, of course, because the defending champion has
eight.
To open up as well. So, but yeah, it's something players, particularly now, have to get used to. These two gentlemen won't have done it too often, but now you've got Euro Tours, Players' Championships, and like you said, the Worlds, and
46.
A lot of darts to play.
Well, let's play a game of, let's guess what's in John Part's head. Would he rather play Phil Taylor on this evening, knowing for weeks that he's going to play him, preparing for that match, or would he rather play him having just won 4-0 and taken out 164 in the last leg earlier in the night?
Okay. Either or, really, with John. I think, obviously, the manner in which he won, yeah, he's happy that he's won that. Any sort of confidence you can take when you're playing Phil Taylor, John would have took from that routing of Paul Lim. Yeah, John, who's gone deep in the UK Open on a few occasions.
100.
So he'll have played games in a day. Won the first ever European Tour, the second ever European Tour to be played, which was actually held in Minehead.
Well, this is a rivalry that maybe went under the radar of time. Of course, they had those showpiece matches in the World Championship Finals. Taylor winning 7-0 at the Tavern in 01. Part getting his revenge 2 years later.
John always tells me about a UK
99.
Open game where they were level at 10 apiece.
94.
And Phil went off to use the toilet, and he always says it was mind games. It comes up, he doesn't let things go, John.
Well, Taylor's not letting much go in this match. Part looks
74.
Over his shoulder,
John,
but he knows he needs this kind
14.
Of finish to just stop Taylor in his tracks.
Still on, treble 20 for the ball. Nah, it's not happening with John Part. I wonder
31.
How much that first leg would have settled
John
him, or how much
20.
Is bugging John at the minute, because he just can't get to grips with Taylor.
Game shot on the first leg, Phil Taylor! Second leg, John to throw first. Game on.
It's a walk in the park so far for Phil Taylor. I mean, we've only played three legs. He's averaging in the mid-80s. That is about where he was in that defeat to Kevin Painter.
He looked hot and bothered against Peter Manley and Kevin Painter. He looked a lot more relaxed. Whether the darts, yes, like you said, it's a similar standard. He looks more confident, and that is something to work on. He's allowed to settle into his game. John just needs to try and give him something to think about in this match.
Yeah, part average 81.33 in that 4-0 win against Paul Lim.
And 100. John Powell's lost the opening three legs, but if he can hold here, find a break, all of a sudden it's one set all, and it puts a real different complexion on the tie.
85.
Yes, our good friend and colleague John Quinn used to say, if you hold your throw, you never know. It was great to share the commentary box with John at the World Seniors Championship. 60. If you're watching, John, hope you're doing well, mate.
Yeah, echo that. Great bloke, John Quinn. Sure he's commentated on many a classic between these two.
58.
Yeah, many a meeting between the pair. And Phil Taylor unsurprisingly leads that head-to-head. 31 wins to 6 for John Part. But a couple 95. Of firsts. They've never met at the Lakeside before. They've never met at the World Masters.
Yeah, John Part looking to make inroads here. Top for Party.
78.
And will be back, but yeah, not happy that last start. But there's a lot more fluency in that throw there. He was a bit passive when attacking that tops in the first leg of the match.
John Newcomb, 40.
When it came to crucial finishing, John Part was very, very strong against Paul Lim. Is this crucial?
No score.
Just Phil drags it down. Phil Taylor. To race to a two-set lead. Options 17 or a 9. Tops 4, a 2 set lead.
69
over the top.
John Urquhart,
saving grace for John Part is that he's coming back 4 tops. Having hit the double 15 rather than the single with that miss.
Needs a settler here, John. You've been missing doubles early. Big moment for John Part.
20.
And again, drags it down. And it's looking like 40. Phil Taylor is going to have 4 consecutive legs to open his match and go into a 2-set lead.
Game
and that's exactly what has happened. It's easy so far for Phil Taylor. The power has won all 4 legs, just as John Part did at this stage in his earlier match against Paul Lim. Maybe we are seeing a resurgent Taylor, who leads at the break by 2 sets to 0. Welcome back to the action here at the Lakeside, where the legendary Phil Taylor is enjoying a walk in the park against Part so far. John Part, who got the better of Paul Lim earlier this evening and produced the moment of the evening with a stunning Party piece, 1-6-4 checkout, has been unable to rediscover that fire against the power, who so far he's true to his word. Improved.
First set, first leg, it's John to throw first.
It'd been interesting to see his approach if John Part had taken that opening leg. He's been allowed to settle here. But Party will not give up. He knows how quickly this format can turn around.
61.
But will be concerned. He's been very scrappy at the end of legs and he's had the chances and gifted Phil Taylor a couple of legs. Taylor 2 sets away. Victory here.
Winner of this match to take on John Lowe or Les Wallace in the quarterfinals on Sunday. The winner will be the first 96. Man through to the last 8. Of course, the other 3 matches tonight have been prelim affairs. A quick reminder, tomorrow we're back on air at 1 p.m. starting with Lisa Ashton against Tony O'Shea before Terry Jenkins meets Richie House, and then it's Dieter Hedman against Colin Monk before Martin Adams meets Wayne Jones.
Yeah, good tie to end the afternoon. Wayne Jones is positive as ever in his interviews, but
got
the job done. Very hard himself, Wayne Jones, but got the job done. And a good tie with Martin Adams to wrap up what will be a brilliant afternoon session here at the Lakeside tomorrow.
Yeah, and that match between Lowe and Wallace kicks off the evening session to find out who plays, well, at the moment, probably the power, but Part will have a thing or two to say about that.
Well, it's a set on his darts. He's got to win this one.
57.
Party just got to hang around, and maybe that first dart he gets into a double will settle him down, because you can dwell on mistakes like that when you know you've had chances.
96.
Next year.
Johnny McCall, 147.
It just ramps the pressure up the next time you ever go at a double.
A 147 on offer here. It isn't going to go, but Taylor's on a similar kind of outshot.
99. Phil Ducar, 139.
Try and leave. Double four, but we'd expect to come back, and is going to come back, Phil Taylor. There's never really been any threat of this sort of finish in the match.
97.
But John again, Ducar, Taylor 48. Waiting in the wings. John Part has been scrappy on the outer ring. Can he be clinical here?
Well, that's now 10 darts missed.
38.
Make it 11 after missing double 10. And Phil Taylor is picking up all of those scraps so far.
Yeah, puff of the cheeks from John Part. The frustration really kicking in now. Taylor to hammer home advantage. 10. No, so a let off for John.
John, you require
well, his fellow
10.
Canadian earlier on, David Cameron, was bob on double 5. Can John Part follow suit here?
How about double 2?
6.
Just not happening, is it,
32.
For John Part here against the power? Sense of inevitability now. You can bounce off that.
Oh, is he going to get another go? John Part, every leg he's thrown first has been in a great
leg.
Position to win first the leg. And it's an apology from Phil Taylor, but John Part knows that.
Game on.
He's let this slip away, and Phil Taylor saying, Phil Taylor knows he's not playing well. You heard him there. Come on, he knows he can play better. He's just getting away with it, but John Part is leaving himself a lot to do here.
60.
Well, he's missed a dozen darts at double in the match, John Part.
Don't
give up, John Part. Keep chipping away, but it's a sizable task for him now.
It's actually 13 darts, so I apologise. Just like Phil Taylor did twice. Once right in Party's face. Sorry, John, he said. Mind games from the master.
80.
Dart players never who apologise, they never mean it. It's just a...
It's a reminder, isn't it, that you've just missed a load of doubles.
Yeah, it is. It's
99.
John Part just got to tell himself at the minute, if he can break back here, he'd have the darts then to throw for the set. I mean, it's easier said than done, but just trying to break down this comeback into sections.
78.
Yeah, if is one of the smallest and biggest words in the English language, and in this format in particular, there are loads of moments where you might think to yourself, if I could have just hit that, or if he'd have just missed that. So many big legs.
Yeah, but John, he's going to get a chance to lay up the 175 here. Six darts at it, and he hasn't really had a look on the throw of Phil Taylor, but...
77.
We'll return at 98. But how's the setup going to be from Phil Taylor?
I think I could just see Dennis Priestley peering in the background there.
80. Johnny require 98.
Too many wayward darts from Phil Taylor, and he's in a position of comfort, but John Part, is he going to get a leg on the board? He may do. Double 16.
Brilliant from John. The second leg.
When you've been missing doubles like John has, to take a finish out like that. And now, like I said, he has a chance to half the deficit in set score. And a real clean finish from John Part. And I said he wouldn't give up, and true to his word, Party has a chance to ignite this last 16 tie.
44.
Yeah, couldn't hit a double and then rescues that 98 shot. Part for parity in set three. But here comes Taylor. Here comes Phil Taylor. Just when John Part thought he found his way, Phil Taylor knocks him off course with the first maximum 41. Of this match.
Yeah, real kick in the teeth for John Part, and Phil Taylor now very much the favourite to lead 3-0 and very much the favourite to advance
61
to that quarter final. Now with John Lowe or Les Wallace, and he'd be a massive favourite in that as well. Massive favourite all weekend, Phil Taylor, but was fragile up in Purfleet. He's not been at his best. And I think this will disappoint John the most when he looks over at Phil's average and knows he hasn't been as competitive as he knows he can be.
Yeah, based on what we did see at the Circus Tavern, even at this level, you would expect to see Phil Taylor get the better of Wallace or Lowe.
John Lowe was beaten by Dave Prinz. Les Wallace rallied against John Walton, but couldn't complete the turnaround.
Will it be a Taylor Wonderland here at the Lakeside? Of course, was one of the key figures in the formation of the PDC, so actually didn't appear at the Lakeside that often. This is actually only seventh televised tournament at this venue.
96,
his 22nd match. He won 17 of his previous 21.
Yeah, featured. Well, in the first PDC.
111.
Lost the final, lost to our co-commentator is like Dennis Priest in the final, but from there on in, it was Taylor dominance. Had his revenge on Dennis Priestley many a time.
115, building up past 16.
So for 3-0, he started this leg with a maximum.
Game,
and he ends it
first set
on double eight. And one more set would end John Park's participation at the World Seniors Masters.
Yeah, John Park will be kicking himself there because he got down to 62 and he wasn't really competitive at the beginning of the leg and doesn't find a shot. And now Phil Taylor, one set, two legs away from being our first quarter finalist. And whilst not at his best, has never looked in any danger. It's all been a bit too much for John Park. He started 100. The evening beating Paul Lim. We've then seen victories for David Cameron in a thriller. There's Kevin Painter. Wayne Jones beating Roland Scholten by 4-1. And this one is our first last 16 tie.
One of the
but hang about. John Part.
You can never write him off, can you? The dogged, determined Darth Maple.
80.
Will we see the grimace, the snarl from John Part as he tries to launch a comeback here?
One of the most tenacious tungsten tossers over the years.
58.
Just see a little practice swing there from Part in the background.
95.
Still knows in this format he can cause Taylor a problem or two, if not work his way back into the match.
He goes again.
140.
And lucky that John Part
is causing him a problem or two in this leg, isn't he?
He is, and he's going to get a shot at the 1-2-3. Will Phil Taylor? Well, I was going to say, would he switch at the last start, but he's going to leave a finish regardless now. Really good switching from Phil. John Part with a 1-6-4 party piece to win the match earlier, but this one, just to give him a stranglehold in his fourth set, not going to go. It's looking ominous for John Part.
Building up by 89.
Yeah, this would be a bit of a crusher. Treble 18. Park 81. Comes back. 81.
John, you require 80.
But no margin now. No error allowed.
Double 10. We've been dragging low on this a lot. Big dart for Part. And just goes 70. Inside. Story of the match for John Parton. Whilst Phil Taylor's not been at his best. Top players in the world, when they're not playing the best, have the...
Game shown the first leg. Phil Taylor!
The knack of finding a way. And Phil Taylor is one leg away from completing a rout on what would be our second whitewash of the evening. John Part started it all, but looks 100. Like he's going to be on the receiving end here.
Yeah, the tale of two ties for John Part. Got the party started, but now
135.
Looks likely to depart the World Seniors Darts Masters here at Lakeside.
It would be some turnaround, wouldn't it? But
100.
Had chances, John Part. Lots of them as well, not just little stabs here and there. And it could have all been so different. Matches aren't won in the opening leg, but they can dictate how they go. And I stand by, that's what's happened here.
40.
John Part missing darts at tops, but he pulled it into the five, didn't he? So the shot ended, and since then, it's been one-way traffic. One leg, a solitary leg for John Part. Phil Taylor 22. Is cruising, it looks like, to the quarterfinals.
Well, it will be interesting to see what Taylor says to Helen Chamberlain at the end of this match, which could be any moment now.
100.
Because, yes, it is looking like a breeze. A whitewash win. A clean sweep of sets against the great John Part. But having gone away and said he's going to put things right and perform better, he hasn't really done that.
126.
Hasn't been forced into action, though, has he? So that's what he can clutch to. But this, to finish the job, he'll go for it. Bullseye, as he's setting up. Well, he went for it, and that's a great effort. But unless John Park can find a 1-4-2, it's looking like Phil Taylor is through to the quarterfinals.
I think he shared a little joke with Paul Hinks there. I think Mr. Hinks called
Phil Lucas, John 25.
Phil. Now Park would like to reverse the scoreline. Is this the end? It is for John Park.
As
Taylor takes out the double eight and completes a whitewash win against his old rival at the Lakeside to book his place in the quarterfinals. And we'll catch a word with the power now. He's talking to Helen Chamberlain.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. John Part. I'll wait. Thanks very much, John. I'm waiting to see.
I know you are.
I'm waiting to see what you've got to say about that.
Getting better. Not as good as I thought it would be, I'll be honest with you, but... Thank you. I think I'll improve the next round now. A little bit of nerves again. I don't know why, but I'm just a little bit nervous again. Why, I don't know, but it's just a game, to be honest with you. But
yeah, but it is a comeback, so, and you're at Lakeside, yes. And, you know, yeah. We're live.
This is my first World Championship, was on this stage against Eric Bristow. So it brings back so many memories for me. Can I just say one word? Can I just say a big thank out for John Gwynn? He gave Bob a ring yesterday.
Love Gwynny. Love John. Yeah, love you, John.
Do. We all do.
Yeah. Oh, that's smashing. Yeah.
And he's not well, but, you know, he's contacted us, and massive big thank you for John Gwynn. Not just for him, for his career.
Yeah, love you, John.
We all love John.
So, back to the game. You said, I think I'll be better next round.
I was a little bit better, but second round is a different kettle of fish, so
yes.
I've got the day off tomorrow and then get ready for Sunday, so I'll have a practice tomorrow. get ready for Sunday.
There's a lot of expectation on you anyway, every time you step onto the board, but also, you know, the final game tonight, you playing John Park, because you've had some massive ding-dongs over the years, and all right, fair enough, you can say that wasn't one tonight,
no.
But it was still important, it was still very important. You don't want to be going home.
John missed doubles, that's all John did. He missed doubles at the wrong times, and then, because it would have changed the game. When he was 1-0 down, he missed doubles, and I took the set, and it was a difficult game for John. I think I put him under pressure a little bit.
I was watching your body language. You were sometimes quite apologetic, going up and just nicking your darts out the board.
I'm always apologetic. But I won't be apologetic on Sunday, trust me. I'm out to win it now. So I've got past the first round, but you don't know who you're playing. You're playing somebody that's already played the game.
Yeah.
Obviously, he's won't got through the first round, so Sunday it's an equal playing field, so I'll be ready.
Okay. And tomorrow at Wembley to watch Port Vale.
Oh, Port Vale. Our talkie game, on, by the way.
Oh, don't mention it. Ladies and gentlemen, Phil Taylor.
Up the Vale.
Up the Vale.
And next week, I'm watching Robbie Williams.
Oh, lovely. Phil Taylor, ladies and gentlemen. Well done, Phil.
So Phil Taylor moves into the quarterfinals. He'll be back on the Lakeside stage, as he said, on Sunday. Bobby George, what's your verdict on Phil's performance tonight?
Well, not Phil. I mean, Phil took his chances when he got here, took them. But John, disappointed, really. I think it was waiting that time didn't do him any good at all. He couldn't get into the game. All right, missed a lot of shots at doubles, but he was 2 inches off some single numbers, you know.
I'm just curious about John. You play, you win, you go backstage, adrenaline's pumping, then 2 hours later you've got to come back on. It looked like he had nothing left to me.
He got worn out, didn't he?
Yeah.
He just didn't perform at all. But Phil took his chances. Yeah, you can't give Phil chances.
Well, I just thought it was a very, very honest assessment from Phil, talking to Helen there, just saying that I expected to play better. It was a bit better, but there was nothing to get excited about, but that's not a negative. It's like he said he was going to be better this time round, and it's a progress.
He didn't play too bad. He finished better than John did. That's the difference. The difference with Phil, he can, if you give him a chance, he takes it.
Yes.
On the shots out and the doubles, and you can't afford to do that. But John Parr didn't play anywhere like he did against Paul Lynn. Terrible.
So, of course, we can say congratulations to Phil on winning tonight. But we didn't learn lots and lots and lots. We learned that he'd improved, but he said he was going to come back here and he was going to be better. And he said he wasn't going to go through the same experience again that he went through in the Seniors World Championship.
Well, I still think he's got to play better than he did.
Yeah, of course.
To win it, so he knows that. I mean, 4-0, you can't beat better than 4-0, can you?
And one thing, Bob, for Phil Taylor, given what he achieved in the game, what should we realistically expect? He is not going to return to that level again. He can play to a great standard, and that's up to how much work he wants to do. So it's like an expectancy on his shoulders all the time. He expects a lot of himself. I'm not saying no win, but there's a lot on his shoulders.
Yeah, constant pressure on him.
Yeah.
Every time he goes on the stage, because he scored so well and he played so well all the time, now he's got to learn to play a game well. Because if you don't use it, you lose it. And that's what he's been doing. But he must have practiced better. And he will go home and practice, then come back and see how he does on Sunday.
So have you enjoyed tonight?
Lovely.
It's been terrific, isn't it? I wondered when we get to that.
I know.
Of course, we're going to be back tomorrow. Let's take a check and see what games we've got lined up for tomorrow as this tournament starts to make some progress. OK, Bob, forecast time. Lisa Ashton against Tony O'Shea. Lisa's got a terrific game right now. Tony's had some great moments on the Lakeside stage. That's just a call, isn't it?
Lisa's such a great lady player. She could be him. You know, over them sort of short formats, she could actually. I'm not saying she would. But she can frighten him.
Okay.
Because she's a tidy player.
Terry Jenkins, Richie Howson, both did well in the Seniors World Championship at the Circus Tavern.
I thought Richie Howson, he's a very good dark player.
Yes, he is.
He qualifies all the time, so he might have a little bit of help and get through.
Deesa Hedman against Colin Monk.
I would say Colin Monk. Peter played good darts.
It'll
as well.
Be close.
But
and Martin Adams, well, Martin's relationship with the Lakeside Country Club is absolutely immense. He was here in the WDF a while or so ago, and he didn't have a great day, actually, but we saw him have play very well in the World Championship because he got to the final.
Yeah.
Martin Adams against Wayne Jones. Wayne, so, tell you what, he always says he plays badly. He's never happy, is he?
Every time he wins, he plays badly, he says. I've never talked to him after he's lost, so I don't know what the answer is. He does it all the time.
So we're looking forward to it tomorrow. We've had four matches tonight. We've got four more tomorrow afternoon. We've got four more tomorrow night. When we get to Sunday, Sunday is going to be absolutely crazy. Because four quarterfinals, two semi-finals, and the final on Sunday night. The Jennings Bet World Seniors Darts Masters is underway. Time for us to go, but we hope you'll join us tomorrow. Say goodnight, Robert.
Good night. And may the darts be with you.
Bye for now.